Let us continue, guys, with the second class of cost and management accounting. We did the introduction part yesterday, guys, nothing much. But let us quickly revise whatever we did yesterday. First thing that I told you as to cost is nothing but the amount of expenditure that is attributable to a particular product. The amount of expenditure attributable as such, guys. Costing beta is nothing but the process or technique of arriving or ascertaining the cost of the end product as such, guys. Or it can be the service that is being rendered or activity or process, guys. After that, but I told you, of course, why is costing important as such, guys? Even to arrive at the correct price of a product, you will need the accurate cost of a product as such, but in case you want to achieve competitive leadership in the market, guys, through competitive advantage in the market through cost leadership as such, guys, you would again be needing to manufacture the product at the least possible cost. Cost object, guys, is the end product or the end service, guys, or some other department or some process for which cost is to be ascertained, guys. We took few examples of cost objects. Cost unit, guys, is the unit of measurement. Again, but we have segregated cost units into simple unit and composite cost unit. A simple cost unit beta is that there's only a single measure of unit, guys. A composite cost unit beta is a combination of two or more cost units. Combination beta of two or more cost units as such, guys. After that, beta is responsibility center, guys. A responsibility center is something that has been entrusted with some responsibility. It is very important to understand what responsibility centers are in order to know, evaluate the performances as such, guys, of multiple departments. A responsibility center, beta, is segregated into a cost center, a revenue center, guys, a profit center, and then investment center. A cost center, beta, as the name suggests, would be responsible only for cost incurred in that department. So the performance will be evaluated by comparing the standard cost and the actual cost. A revenue center on the other hand, beta, would be responsible only for generating revenue or only for generating sales for the company as such, guys. They will not be responsible for anything else. A profit center, beta, is one that is responsible for both cost as well as revenues of the organization, beta. Investment center, again, is one, beta, that is responsible for the amount of investments made. Performance evaluation, beta, of an investment center can be made in terms of return on investment, residual income. There's a separate chapter, guys, in CA Final Strategic Cost Management, which is performance measurement and evaluation. There we will be learning better about different performance measures that can be used depending upon the type of responsibility center better that we have in place. After that, beta, we moved on to classification of expenses. We did only one classification of expenditure beta the other day, and that is in relation to output. Now, in relation to output, beta, is basically based on variability, guys, of expenditure. I repeat, based on variability of expenditure, guys. We divide the expenses beta into variable cost, fixed cost, semi-variable cost, and step fixed cost. Variable cost changes proportionately beta with the change in output. The cost per unit will always remain constant unless otherwise given, and the total variable cost will change. Economies of scale will not apply here unless there is specific information given here. Then beta, fixed cost, total cost will remain constant irrespective of the output level, while the cost per unit will obviously change. Semi-variable beta is partly variable and partly fixed cost. Because it's a combination of both variable and fixed cost, guys, both total cost and cost per unit will not remain constant with the change in output. Step fixed cost beta is a type of fixed cost only. The total cost will remain constant within a given range of activity, guys. Beyond that range beta, your total cost will increase but would remain constant for the next level of activity. I repeat beta, it would remain constant for the next level of activity. Now, we have learned beta. That I told you guys, if total cost and cost per unit are not constant, guys, you have to assume it to be semi-variable expenditure. Now, there are different methods beta for segregating semi-variable cost into variable and fixed. The first method that we did beta was change in activity method, the most logical method, common sense, guys. Here beta, it says the total change in cost beta from one activity level to the other activity level. I repeat, the change in total cost beta from one activity level to the other activity level beta will be on account of variable cost. So you can always say beta that change in cost is the incremental variable cost of the incremental output, guys. Incremental variable cost of the incremental output beta. Now, once we get variable cost per unit, we can arrive at fixed cost. The other method beta is high-low method. It is similar to change in activity method, but instead of picking up any two activity levels, you're supposed to pick up the highest activity and the lowest activity. That is how you will arrive at variable cost per unit. Then beta, we also did graphical method, wherein you're supposed to plot all the points on a graph as such, guys. Wherever the line cuts the y-axis beta, that will be the amount of fixed cost. An analytical method, guys, where the experienced staff would analyze and segregate the expenses, beta, into variable and fixed. Lastly, beta, we also did method of least squares, guys, that is simultaneous equations method. Under method of least squares, we form an equation of the form y is equal to mx plus c. Here, beta, m is the amount of variable cost per unit, c is the amount of fixed cost, y is total cost, x is number of units. So, using two activity levels, beta, your job is to arrive at the values of m and c, guys. Once we get m and c, beta, we know what is the variable cost per unit, and then we know what is the amount of fixed cost. This is what we did, beta. We are yet to discuss a lot of other classification of expenses. Just for your information, beta, I'm re-recording the entire class because the other class that I recorded as such, beta, had a lot of audio issue as such, guys. So yeah, that's sort of a punishment for me, guys, for punishing you guys, whatever, guys. Okay, before I start the other classification of expenses, guys, I would want to add something more, better to your understanding of a responsibility center. Usually, guys, we have the CEO of the organization sitting on the top. Now say, guys, under CEO, beta, say there's a production department, say there's a sales department, okay, say, beta, there's a research and development department, and so on. Your production department, but guys, usually is a cost center. This is again, beta, examples for responsibility centers. Sales department, beta, usually is a revenue center. Usually, beta, is a revenue center. Research and development department, beta, again is a cost center. Do not forget, beta, is a discretionary cost center. It is not even a standard cost center. Okay, I hope you remember that, guys. CEO of the organization, beta, would be both a profit center as well as an investment center. He would be responsible for the entire amount of investments that are being made in the firm, guys, as well as, beta, the amount of profits that the firm is generating. No doubt about it, beta, that he will be responsible, guys, for both the amount of investments that are being made in the firm, guys, as well as the amount of profits that the organization is generating. This is just an example, guys, for your understanding as to what the CEO of an organization does. Apart from that, beta, we can also take other examples as such, guys. Say, for example, again, beta, responsibility center ka, say you have Tata Motors. Ek second, beta, kya message aa raha hai yaar ye bar bar. Yes, beta, say you have Tata Motors as such, guys. Under Tata Motors as such, beta, say you have a separate division, passenger vehicles ka division hai. Okay, and say you have a separate division, beta, say for commercial vehicles. For commercial vehicles, how many doubts do you people ask? Then, beta, there is financing department. They can obviously, beta, Tata Motors has a finance department also. Yes or no, guys? Now, passenger vehicles, beta, in turn can have a production department, can have a sales department, so on, beta. This sales department, beta, can be a revenue center, can be a revenue center. This, beta, will be a cost center. Your whoever is the head of passenger vehicles as such, beta, would be both a profit center and an investment center. Try to get the point, beta, here. Whoever is the head of passenger vehicles will be both, beta, a profit center as such, beta, and an investment center, guys. Commercial vehicles may be, beta, as a segregation aega. So if you're copying this, beta, you can just write examples of responsibility centers and copy, guys. Examples of responsibility centers. You can copy this, guys. If you are copying, nahin, you have to copy. There is no option given to you. You can copy this, beta, as examples of responsibility centers, guys, and make a note of it. Theek hai? Sab log copy karo, beta, ye. Please make a note of this, guys. All of you, beta, make a note of this. I'm assuming you're done with this, beta. Now write this: Tata Motors ka, passenger vehicles, commercial vehicles, financing department, टाटा मोटर्स के नीचे बेटा यू कैन राइट पैसेंजर व्हीकल्स, कमर्शियल व्हीकल्स, फाइनेंसिंग डिपार्टमेंट, यस बेटा ओके गाइज आई एम अज्यूमिंग यूर ऑल डन विद इट बेटा, जस्ट इन केस यू आर नॉट डन विद इट येट गाइज यू कैन पॉज द स्क्रीन एंड देन कॉपी इन केस यू आर नॉट डन विद इट येट गाइज बिकॉज यू जस्ट हैव टू राइट दीज वर्ड्स नथिंग एल्स. नाउ गाइज मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट एस्पेक्ट बेटा हियर द नेक्स्ट क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एक्सपेंसेज बेटा इज बेस्ड ऑन फंक्शंस परफॉर्म्ड. नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी सिंपल वन बेटा, देयर इज नो एक्सप्लेनेशन. Unlike the first one, beta, that was based on variability or relation of expenditure to output, guys. This one is pretty simple, guys. Based on functions performed, beta, we classify the expenses. Based on functions performed, we classify the expenses, guys, into we have manufacturing expenses. We have manufacturing expenses. Sun lo ghado. We have selling and distribution expenditure. Selling and distribution expenditure, guys. Then, beta, we have office and administrative expenditure, office and administration cost. And then we can have, say, research and development. Research and development. All of these, but these are the categories of expenses, guys, based on functions performed. Now, when you say manufacturing expenditure as such, guys, it can be the raw material of the product. It can be depreciation of machinery, raw material, wages paid to the employees as such, but who are manufacturing the product, depreciation, say, of machinery, but power cost. All of these are your manufacturing expenses. The list will just go on, guys. Anything better that is directly in relation or anything better that is in relation to manufacturing of the end product better but obvious would be a manufacturing expenditure and would be classified as manufacturing cost. Selling and distribution cost as such, guys, you can segregate selling and distribution into selling also and distribution also. Distribution ka matlab hota hai beta the expenditure incurred in delivering the product to the end consumer. Matlab say guys, from your factory gate it goes in those trucks to the warehouses, from warehouses say if they go to stockist and then they go to wholesalers. So whatever beta this expenditure that you are incurring as such beta would be your distribution cost. Say for the purpose of transportation you need special packaging, you are packaging the products again beta in containers, so that is again distribution cost beta. Selling cost beta can be your advertisement, promotional expenditure as such, guys, in order to, you know, sales commissions that you are giving. So all of that beta will be selling cost. So this will be beta transportation cost, sales commission, etc. I'm just giving one two examples beta for your understanding. So selling and distribution expenditure, guys. Office and administration cost beta, you'll always have a finance department, you have the front office department processing invoices as such, guys, processing payments, all of that beta will be office and administrative cost as such, guys. Admin department, basically administration department cost. R&D cost to pata hi hai beta, research and development cost, you do not have to have a second thought about R&D cost. So yes beta, this is the class or this is your you know the next category of expenditure that is based on functions performed, a very simple one, guys. Iske baad mein aayega very interesting one beta, the elements of cost, guys, material, labor and other expenses. I will be explaining that beta in detailed manner. Now you can copy this. When I say copy beta, copy then only, not before that. Listen to the explanation, always listen to the explanation, guys. You are supposed to copy this beta in your notes. Copy properly. Yes, beta, are you all doing it? Yes, guys. Okay, beta, I'm assuming you're all done with this. So this is based on functions performed as beta, wherein we got manufacturing expenses and then we got selling and distribution, office and administration cost, research and development. The next category, beta, are the elements of cost. The elements of cost. Now this is a very important category as such, beta, because this only becomes, this will become your subsequent three chapters, guys. Now elements of cost, beta, are material, labor and other expenses. We can divide all the cost elements as such, beta, into these three categories: material, labor and other expenses. Undoubtedly, beta, when I say material, guys, I am referring to inventories. I am referring to your inputs that are being used as such, beta, to manufacture the product. The inputs in the form of materials, beta, that are being used to manufacture the product. When I say labor, beta, it is the manpower that is working, guys. It is the manpower that is working in the organization, the salaries that are being paid. It doesn't make a difference, guys, whether it is a factory worker working on manufacturing the product directly or whether it is a professional labor, beta, sitting in the front office and performing some other task. For the purpose of costing, guys, labor is labor. There is no differentiation. We will say labor, beta, and any manpower as such, beta, cost will be termed as a labor expenditure, guys, under cost records. And then of course, beta, we have other expenses. Anything that does not come into the category of material and labor, beta, would come under the category of other expenses. Just say if you have power expenditure, guys, power cost, electricity bills. If you have, say, beta, depreciation of equipments, guys, aise beta, the list can continue, guys. If you have, say, crane hire charges or equipment hire charges, equipment leasing charges, rentals paid as such, guys, all of that, beta, will come under other expenses. So remember, these are the three elements of cost, guys. We can divide our expenses into these three categories. You have material, you have labor, and then, beta, you have other expenses. Material, labor, beta, and other expenses, guys. These are the three categories as such, guys. Under material also, beta, we can divide the expenses into direct material and indirect material. Under material also, beta, I can divide the expenditure, guys, into direct material and indirect material. Now this is important, guys. Any expenditure, beta, that can be directly identified, that can be directly identified with the end product being manufactured or service being rendered, beta, is termed as a direct cost. Anything, beta, that you can directly identify with the end product. Directly identify with the end product matlab physical visibility ki baat nahi kar raha, guys. I am not telling you, beta, that it should be physically present in the end product. It is not like labor, beta, is physically present in the end product. But even under labor, beta, I will have direct labor cost, indirect labor cost. I will have direct labor cost, beta, and indirect labor cost even under the labor. Even under other expenses, beta, I will have direct expenses, I will have indirect expenses. Under every category as such, beta, here we have direct and indirect, beta. Under every category, beta, here we have direct and indirect. Please understand, guys, anything that is directly identifiable, any expenditure beta that is directly identifiable with the end product that is being manufactured and service beta that is being rendered will be termed as a direct cost. Any expenditure, guys, any expenditure, you are not supposed to copy, you are supposed to listen. Any expenditure beta that is directly identifiable with the end product, with the end product being manufactured or service being rendered, with the end product being manufactured but or service being rendered, is termed as direct cost. ये समझो बेटा पहले. अ प्रॉब्लम यही है गाइस, दैट अ मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द एक्सपेंसेस गाइस इन एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बेटा वुड बी इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट. मतलब इट इज नॉट डायरेक्टली आइडेंटिफाइबल विद वन पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट असर बेटा, बट अल्टीमेटली इट इज इंकर्ड फॉर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो बेटा कॉस्टिंग जो कॉम्प्लिकेटेड प्रोसेस अपन बोलते हैं ना बेटा, दैट कॉस्टिंग कैन बिकम अ कॉम्प्लिकेटेड प्रोसेस, इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ दिस इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट ओनली. When you say beta costing can become a complicated process as such, guys, it is because of the presence of this indirect cost as such beta. This indirect expenses only as such beta, which indirect expenses, how will you allocate to multiple people? These indirect expenses, just say beta factory rent is being incurred. Now factory rent that you are incurring beta is in respect of all the products that are being manufactured. I cannot say that factory rent is identifiable with this particular product. Factory rent beta will obviously be beta for all products put together. It is not for a particular product. Factory rent beta will become an indirect expenditure. Now, how will you be apportioning that rent beta to the multiple products that are being manufactured will be a very big question. Yahi pe beta, your costing procedures are important. Anyone can identify direct cost as such beta, but identification of indirect cost or, you know, allocating that indirect cost as such beta to multiple products on a very systematic basis will result in true costing of a product. Only then you will know the accurate cost of a product. Abhi beta, ye samajhne ke liye, pehle to itna samjho beta that any expenditure that is directly identifiable with the end product that is being manufactured or service being rendered is termed as direct cost. Ab guys, under direct material, if you want me to take an example, guys, say you are manufacturing wooden benches. If you are manufacturing wooden benches, make a list of all the materials that are required, guys. Make a list of all the materials that are required, beta. That will be direct material. You make a list. Jaise beta, I was telling you that to manufacture, I will be telling you. Ab wo kya ho gaya, beta? As I told you that I skipped, as in the class got this thing damaged. So to manufacture an iPhone as such, beta, there are roughly 36 components required. All of those 36 components that you see in the end product as such beta, though it is not visible to the eye as such beta, or which are used to manufacture the iPhone beta, would be your direct materials. Would be direct materials as such, guys. For a wooden bench, guys, obviously you will need wood beta, you will need iron or steel, guys, you will need some paint as such beta, you will need say nuts, bolts, jo bhi hai guys, all of this beta would become your direct material cost. So sir, indirect kya hoga? Indirect materials beta can be tools and consumables of machineries. Indirect materials beta can be tools and consumables of machineries. For machineries as such beta, won't you need, say guys, I am using a crane as such guys. Wo crane mein beta bar bar thode materials change karne padte, say every 1 month, every 2 months I have to keep changing materials of that. Now that is not being directly identified with the end product beta, but then it is assisting in the manufacturing of end product. So yes, it would be indirect material. So the tools and consumables of the machineries that we use as such guys, spare parts, would become indirect material. Would become, guys, the cotton that you use for the machinery, the grease that you use for the machinery as such, guys, the conveyor belts that keep that are changed frequently as such, beta, all of them beta would be examples of indirect material. All of them beta would be examples of indirect material as such, guys. So yes, beta, we divide our material cost into two categories, that is direct material cost, beta, and indirect material cost. Direct material cost, beta, as I told you here, we took an example beta of wooden benches. I said anything that is there. Tum log kuch bhi le sakte ho beta. Dusre cheez hai example. Say if you want to manufacture a particular cell phone. Say guys, you're manufacturing a cell phone beta here. Now anything that is being used as such guys in the manufacturing of this cell phone directly, all the raw materials and the components that are being used would be direct materials. But to manufacture this cell phone as such, beta, they might also be needing equipments, machineries, guys. So the tools of those equipments, the tools of those machineries as such, beta, would be indirect material. Would be indirect material. समझ में आ रहा है नहीं आ रहा है बेटा? Yes sir, चंगा समझ में आ गया. Sir, वैसे ही sir, direct labor, indirect labor, sir, what will you say, sir? What will you say about direct labor and indirect labor? Guys, direct labor is basically the wages of the workers manufacturing the product. This would be the wages of workers manufacturing product who are directly involved in manufacturing the product as such, beta, unke whatever labor charges that you are paying, beta, would be direct labor. Indirect labor, beta, say can be factory security. Factory security के लिए you have hired people. They are not directly involved in manufacturing activity, beta. But the salaries that are payable to them is still a labor cost. Is still a labor cost. Supervisor. Supervisor is not directly involved in manufacturing any activity, any product as such, beta. But the salary that you pay to the supervisor as such, guys, the salary that you are paying to the supervisor as such, beta, would still come, guys, under the category of, would still come, beta, under the category of labor. Bifurcation samjho beta, he is directly involved in manufacturing that product, so I know whatever wages that I am paying him can be identified with that product. Whatever are the other support functions that are being performed as such, guys, whatever are the other support functions that are being performed as such, beta, would become indirect labor. If I take an educational institution as such, guys, the salary that is paid to the lecturer would be a direct cost. The salary that is paid to a lecturer as such, beta, would be a direct cost. The salary that is being paid to the admin staff as such, beta, would be an indirect cost. The salary that is being paid to the admin staff, beta, would be indirect cost. The salary that is being paid to the lecturer as such, beta, would be direct cost. I hope you're all understanding this. Other expenses mein beta, direct expenses. Say if you have equipment hired for a particular contract. You are hiring an equipment beta for a particular contract. You are hiring an equipment beta for a particular contract as such, guys. Indirect expenses, guys. Indirect expenses beta, yahan pe design charges bhi aa sakta hai guys. So a particular you have received a necklace manufacturing contract, necklace manufacturing order as such, guys. You have to get that particular necklace designed as such, beta. Now whatever are the design charges that are payable as such, guys, would be a direct expenditure identifiable with that particular job. Identifiable, very common beta for designers, huh? Indirect expenses beta can be power cost incurred for all the products put together, not directly identifiable with any particular product. It can be depreciation of equipments. The list will go on. I am telling you again, guys, it is not a direct cost beta. The real fun of the entire costing procedure, guys, is in identifying the proper apportionment, proper allocation beta of indirect expenses. We should be able to identify how much portion of indirect cost should be allocated to which product. Because if something goes wrong, beta, in this allocation, if something goes wrong in this apportionment as such, guys, your entire calculation will go for a toss. If something goes wrong in this calculation as such, beta, with this allocation as such, beta, the entire costing of a product, beta, will go for a toss. So I hope you have understood what this, beta. There are three elements of cost, guys. Material, labor, and other expenses. Material, labor, and other expenses. Under each of these categories, beta, we have further segregation. Material is segregated into direct material, indirect material. Labor, beta, is segregated into direct labor and indirect labor. Other expenses, beta, are segregated into direct expenses and indirect expenses. All direct costs, huh? Anything beta that is identifiable with the end product that is manufactured beta will be a direct cost. Now understand, guys. All direct expenses put together are termed as prime cost. Ye naya word sikha rahe ho sir? Haan sikha raha ho. Sun lo fir. So basically beta, prime cost beta will be equal to direct material, direct wages, that is direct labor, and direct expenses. Also, guys, all indirect expenses are termed as overheads. All indirect expenses beta are termed as overheads. If you recollect as such beta, couple of days back, Tanish was asking some doubt in a Zoom session, guys. He said, sir, you were telling something about direct overheads. There was this one question beta in accounting standard 2, wherein they gave direct material, they gave direct labor, and they gave direct overheads. Then beta, while explaining that question, I said that it doesn't make sense to use the word direct overhead. The fact that you're using the word overhead, it means it is an indirect cost. How can you say that an indirect cost is direct in nature? So guys, they did not use the wording properly, but it should have been variable overhead. Matlab, it is an indirect expenditure, but variable in nature. It is a indirect. Huh? So that would have been a much appropriate usage better than using the word, direct overhead. Anyways, beta, all indirect expenses are termed as overheads. Another important thing, beta, that you should know, beta, is that the segregation of direct and indirect, beta, is done only under manufacturing expenses. Kisme, beta? Manufacturing expenses. This entire segregation, beta, of direct and indirect, beta, is done only under manufacturing expenses. All selling and distribution S&D, matlab selling and distribution. I hope you're all listening, guys. All selling and distribution expenses, office and administrative cost, are indirect expenses only. Matlab wahan pe you directly say beta that selling and distribution overheads, administrative overheads, wahan pe direct cost aata hi nahi hai. It is only under manufacturing head beta that we classify expenses, guys, into direct and indirect. Please understand beta, an expenditure can be variable or fixed or semi-variable. An expenditure can be manufacturing expenditure, selling and distribution expenditure, office or administrative. Expenditure can be in the form of material, labor or other expenses. So I can say beta, it is a manufacturing material cost which is variable in nature. ठीक है. Anyways, beta, this segregation of direct and indirect beta arises only under manufacturing cost. It does not arise beta under selling and distribution or office and administrative cost. उनको तुम सबको beta क्या बोलोगे? They are all indirect expenses. Basically, guys, see, you have direct material. अरे रुक रे. You have direct material, indirect material. हाँ sir है. You have direct labor, indirect labor. हाँ sir. Sir, you have direct expenses, indirect. Yes, sir. All of this put together, sir, is prime cost. And all of this put together, beta, are overheads. I hope this is clear, guys. ये सब समझ में तो आ रहा है ना बेटा, क्या बोलना चाह रहा था मैं. अभी ये कॉपी करो बेटा, एलिमेंट्स ऑफ कॉस्ट. नाउ यू कैन हैप्पीली कॉपी दिस गाइस इन योर नोटबुक, एलिमेंट्स ऑफ कॉस्ट गाइस. Copy with the examples, guys. If just in case you're not able to view something properly as such, but you can zoom in. मैं zoom in कर दूंगा. तुम लोग copy करना शुरू करो. Copy properly, guys. Copy करो बेटा. Just in case you're unable to see, beta, I've zoomed in. You can pause the screen now and then copy. Just in case you were unable to see it, you can pause the screen at this point, guys, and then copy it. अब इससे ज़्यादा क्या करूँ यार मैं? I'm assuming you're done with the upper part, beta. Material, labor, and other expenses. अभी ये करो बाकी का. If you're not done with this beta, pause the screen and then do it. Do it, beta. यस बेटा, आई होप यू आर ऑल डन विद दिस बेटा. जस्ट इन केस समवन इज नॉट डन विद इट बेटा, यू कैन पॉज द स्क्रीन एंड देन कॉपी. जस्ट इन केस यू आर नॉट डन विद इट, आई होप यू हैव प्रॉपरली अंडरस्टूड द सेग्रीगेशन गाइस ऑफ दिस एज टू व्हाट इज डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट, व्हाट इज इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट. बेटा देयर शुड नॉट बी एनी कन्फ्यूजन इन दिस. एनी थिंग दैट यू कैन डायरेक्टली आइडेंटिफाई, आई एम जस्ट रिपीटिंग इट अगैन बेटा, एनी थिंग दैट यू कैन डायरेक्टली आइडेंटिफाई बेटा विद द एंड प्रोडक्ट हैज़ टू बी अ डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट, एंड समेशन ऑफ ऑल डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट एस सच बेटा वुड बिकम योर प्राइम कॉस्ट. समेशन ऑफ ऑल डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट एस सच बेटा वुड बिकम योर प्राइम कॉस्ट. एनी थिंग बेटा दैट इज नॉट डायरेक्टली आइडेंटिफाइबल विद द एंड प्रोडक्ट, एनी थिंग दैट इज नॉट आइडेंटिफाइबल एस सच बेटा विद द एंड प्रोडक्ट, मतलब इट इज अ कॉमन एक्सपेंडिचर बींग इंकर्ड बेटा फॉर मल्टीपल प्रोडक्ट्स, देन गाइज इट विल बिकम एन इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट. इट विल बिकम एन इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट एज सच गाइस. ठीक है, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एक्सपेंडिचर बेटा इज एन इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट बिकॉज इट इज नॉट लाइक यू हैव अ सेपरेट मीटर फॉर ईच प्रोडक्ट. ये प्रोडक्ट का इतना है, ये प्रोडक्ट का इतना है. इफ यू हैव अ सेपरेट मीटर फॉर ईच प्रोडक्ट बेटा विच इज एक्जैक्टली टेलिंग अस एज टू वट इज द अमाउंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी कॉस्ट फॉर ईच प्रोडक्ट एज सच गाइस, देन दैट कैन बी कंसिडर्ड एज डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट. दे कैन बी कॉमन लाइटिंग इन द ऑर्गनाइजेशन एज सच बेटा, ऑल ऑफ दैट बेटा विल बी इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट ओनली. वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ लॉट अबाउट इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट बेटा एज टू हाउ शुड वी बी एलोकेटिंग इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट टू द मल्टीपल प्रोडक्ट्स दैट विल बी मैन्युफैक्चर्ड इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. गाइस बेस्ड ऑन एलिमेंट्स ओनली बेटा वी हैव द नेक्स्ट थ्री चैप्टर्स, ये नहीं लिखे तो भी चलता बेटा, बेस्ड ऑन एलिमेंट्स बेटा वी हैव द नेक्स्ट थ्री चैप्टर्स, नॉट राइट गाइस, द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर दैट आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस बेटा इज मटेरियल, उसके बाद में बेटा वी हैव लेबर एंड उसके बाद में वी डू नॉट हैव अदर एक्सपेंसेस, वी हैव ओवरहेड्स. द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर बेटा दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज मटेरियल एंड नेक्स्ट उसके बाद में बेटा लेबर एंड देन आफ्टर दैट बेटा इज ओवरहेड्स. Okay, now this is another class. So far, beta, we did three classification of expenses. Just a quick recap. We did classification of expenditure, beta, based on behavior, that is in relation to output. We did classification of expenditure based on the functions performed. And then, beta, we did classification of expenditure as such, guys, based on this thing. Abhi kya karte the, beta, last wala? Elements of cost. Now, guys, based on normality of cost. Based on normality of cost. Abhi ye kya hai, sir? Normality of cost. This normality of cost is simple, beta. When I say based on normality of cost, guys, based on normality of cost, beta, we segregate the expenses, guys, into normal cost and abnormal cost. Now, everyone, beta, should know what is normal and abnormal as such, guys. Anything that arises on account of the basic nature of the product as such, guys, or basic nature of the product or the type of production process is termed as normal cost. Anything beta that is over and above this limits as such beta would be termed as abnormal cost. You must have learned about normal loss and abnormal loss a lot, guys. All of you beta must have learned about normal loss and abnormal loss. You should know beta that any amount of normal cost, even if there is abnormal loss as such, guys, even if there is normal loss as such beta, normal loss is always adjusted to the cost of good units. मतलब यू डू नॉट ट्रांसफर दैट टू प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट गाइस, यू एडजस्ट द कॉस्ट ऑफ रिमेनिंग यूनिट्स इज ऑलवेज एडजस्टेड टू द कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड यूनिट्स. अब नॉर्मल कॉस्ट इज सच गाइस, अब नॉर्मल कॉस्ट इज सच बेटा इज ऑलवेज ट्रांसफर टू प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट. अब नॉर्मल कॉस्ट इज सच बेटा इज ऑलवेज ट्रांसफर टू प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट. से गाइस I work for an organization, say guys, I work for RCA as such beta, and they've told me that I'm supposed to teach for 10 hours a day. In that 10 hours as such beta, say I can take a break of 30 minutes for lunch and I can take two other breaks of 15 minutes each. Okay, I repeat again, say I work for RCA as such beta, in a 10 hour session, guys, normally I take up classes from morning 6 to evening 6. Yeah, I start at 6 o'clock in the morning, guys, for CA final. I take the class till 9:15 and then I start my CA inter or CA foundation from 10 o'clock and go until 5:36 in the evening. But say guys, I work for 10 hours as such, guys. उसमें बेटा 10 आवर्स के अंदर से फॉर एग्जांपल आई हैव बीन गिवन अ 30 मिनट्स लंच ब्रेक, हैव बीन गिवन टू ब्रेक्स ऑफ 15 मिनट्स ईच. सो पुट टुगेदर बेटा दे टेल मी दैट यस यू कैन टेक अ ब्रेक ऑफ 1 आवर. दे विल पे मी फॉर 10 आवर्स एज सच बेटा, बट देन दे नो दैट दिस 1 आवर इज अ नॉर्मल आइडियल टाइम, वी कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग अबाउट इट. इफेक्टिव वर्किंग टाइम विल ओनली बी 9 आवर्स. इफेक्टिव वर्किंग टाइम आई एम रिपीटिंग बेटा वुड ओनली बी 9 आवर्स एंड नॉट 10 आवर्स एज सच गाइस. Say, what if, guys, I take a break of more than 1 hour? What if I take a break of more than 1 hour as such, guys? Instead of teaching for an effective time of 9 hours, I waste time and I teach only for 8.5 hours. Say, there is some power cut in the this thing, Beta Academy. There is no power only as such, guys. So, I'm unable to teach. Because there is no power as such, Beta, say, I'm unable to teach. Okay. Now, I thought there was again some problem with the audio, so I just had to look at the sound bar there. So say guys, there was no power at all as such guys in the organization. So yeah, in the academy. So I was unable to teach as such guys. So we wasted another say 30 minutes there. We wasted another 30 minutes. Ye jo 30 minutes waste hua na beta, that will be termed as abnormal idle time. The 30 minutes wasted there as such beta would be termed as abnormal idle time, and that will automatically go to your profit and loss account. The 30 minutes that you have wasted as such beta would be abnormal idle time, guys, and that would automatically go beta to your profit and loss account. Profit and loss account. Samajh mein aa raha hai, guys? So here beta, when I say based on normality of cost, guys, we have normal cost and then we have abnormal cost as such beta. Ye dono to ho chuke. I just gave an example there beta, say 10 hours. 10 hours period in a day beta, 10 hours in a day, isme se beta normal break time is 1 hour, all put together beta is 1 hour, and effective working time beta should be, effective working time, all of you are supposed to listen guys, effective working time beta is 9 hours. Now say beta, due to power cut, actual working hours I'll reduce actual working hours were 7.5 hours only. 7.5 hours. Okay. Say guys, the wages paid per day, beta. Wages paid per day are say 1,000 rupees. Just as an example. Now guys, in order to get effective wage rate per hour, I am not supposed to divide by 10 hours. क्योंकि देखो बेटा 10 hours तो कभी काम करने वाले है ही नहीं. In order to know what is your effective wage rate per hour as such, guys, you should know, beta, that only you should divide 1000 rupees by only 9 hours. No, sir, this is not correct. Why will you divide by 9 hours? I am supposed to divide by 10 hours. Beta, the employee will never work for 10 hours. You pay him for 10 hours. 1000 rupees is undoubtedly the payment for 10 hours. But I am telling you, in order to allocate wages, ultimately, beta, he will work for 9 hours on multiple products. So your effective wages, beta, effective wages per hour, beta, should be 1000 rupees by 9 hours and not by 10 hours. Ye jo normal loss tha, beta, 1 hour, it automatically got adjusted. It automatically got adjusted. Now guys, for 7.5 hours, it will be allocated to products. For 7.5 hours, beta, it will be allocated to the multiple products that were manufactured. Obviously, guys, in this 7.5 hours, he must have manufactured, guys, multiple products. So this 7.5 hours into 111.11 will go to multiple products. और ये जो abnormal idle time है बेटा, abnormal idle time, how much is the abnormal idle time बेटा? 1.5 hours बेटा. Now this should go, guys, this should go to profit and loss account. Please understand, guys, there was a normal idle time of 1 hour. So what we did, beta, we absorbed the entire wages of 1000 rupees as such, guys. We absorbed the entire wages of 1000 rupees as such, beta, by 9 hours only, not by 10 hours. Wo normal idle time should automatically be adjusted to the remaining time of 9 hours. Usme se bhi, beta, effective working 7.5 hours only. That 7.5 hours, beta, will be allocated to multiple products that we are manufacturing. Remaining 1.5 hours will go to profit and loss account. Nahi, sir, give another example. Say guys, 100 units purchased. Another example, beta. 100 units purchased as such, guys. Say at 50 rupees per unit. So my purchases, beta, are say 5000. Okay. 100 units were purchased, beta, at an amount of 50 rupees per unit as such, guys. So my purchases, say, beta, are 5000 rupees. Normal loss, beta, is 5%. Okay, so that is 5 units, beta, should be normal loss. But actual loss, beta, turned out to be 8 units. If actual loss is 8 units, beta, that means abnormal loss, beta, abnormal loss is 3 units. Yes or no? If your actual loss, beta, is 8 units, it means obviously abnormal loss is 8 units. Over and above the normal limit, beta, we are incurring an additional loss of 3 units. Over and above the normal limit, beta, 5 units, we are incurring an additional loss of 3 units. So, yahan pe kya hoga, beta? When you compute the effective cost per unit, you are supposed to divide 5000 not by 100 units. Remember, out of 100 units, 5% is anyways normal loss. Remember, guys, out of 100 units, 5% is anyways normal loss. You were anyways going to get only 95 units. So you are supposed to divide this 5000 rupees, beta, by 95 units. Not by that, beta, 52.6316. Once you get the effect, ye samajh mein aaya na, beta, we are automatically adjusting the cost of normal loss to the remaining good units. We are adjusting the cost of normal loss, beta, to the cost of good units. Now guys, this effective cost per unit jo hai, beta, isme guys, our inventory, beta, is of only 92 units. We did this, beta, in accounting standard 2 also, into 52.6316. Whereas abnormal loss, beta, that should be transferred to profit and loss account, should be 52.6316 into 3 units. So this is 92 beta into 52.6316, 4842, guys. And this is 158 rupees balancing figure, beta. So this is how you should know, beta. This is what we are doing. This will automatically go to profit and loss account. So whenever you have normal loss as such, beta, the cost of normal loss is automatically adjusted to the cost of remaining good units. Abnormal loss, beta, should be transferred to profit and loss account. So I took an example of both wages, guys, as well as this. And now take the example of a fruit vendor as such, guys. Undoubtedly, beta, in case of perishable commodities, In case of perishable commodities, beta, there will be losses. It is very common, guys. So if you see, beta, certain exotic fruits as such, beta, which are sold at the rate of 250 rupees per kg, 300 rupees per kg as such, guys, certain fruits are sold at those rates, 400 rupees per kg, 500 rupees per kg. Their margin, beta, is usually 50% on selling price or 100% on cost. 50% on selling price or 100% on cost. It happened, beta, that I was having a discussion. He says, nahi, margin, sir, is 40% on selling price. I told him, no, you are not making the right statement. He says, नहीं sir, हमार को मालूम है ना, हम business कर रहे हैं, हमारा markup is 40% on selling price. I said, what if there is wastage? थोड़ा तो loss होता होगा ना. He said, हाँ sir, होता है. I said, you factor in that loss and then tell me what is the effective cost per kg of the fruit. You factor that normal loss and then tell me the effective cost per kg. Don't you think, guys, that will make more sense? See, if you are dealing in certain products, say you are dealing in avocados as such, guys, and you know, beta, that there will be a normal loss of 20%. You factor that normal loss of 20% and then tell me what is the effective cost per kg and then talk about your gross margins. That would make more sense. That would obviously make, beta, more sense rather than directly making a statement that my normal markup is so much or my margins are so much. It doesn't work out like that. I hope everyone has understood, guys, as to what is the classification of expenditure based on normality of cost. Now, what are you supposed to do, beta, is copy this part. Please do it, guys. All of you, beta, copy this. Yes, beta, please copy this properly. All of you guys, copy both examples. This is example one and that is example two, guys. Have it in your books properly. Dono examples copy karo, beta. कॉपी करो बेटा प्रॉपरली. हाँ बेटा, हो रहा है क्या? हाँ यस गाइस, यस बेटा, आई बिलीव यू आर ऑल डन विद दिस। ओके, जस्ट इन केस यू आर नॉट डन विद इट बेटा, नाउ इज द टाइम यू पॉज द स्क्रीन एंड देन फिनिश इट ऑफ। ओके, सो गाइस, वी आर डन विद अनदर कैटेगरी ऑफ एक्सपेंडिचर गाइस, एंड दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन नॉर्मैलिटी ऑफ कॉस्ट। नाउ लेट अस मूव टू बेटा द नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी एंड विच इज बेस्ड ऑन कंट्रोलेबिलिटी। बेस्ड ऑन कंट्रोलेबिलिटी गाइस, let us move to the next category of expenditure guys, which is based on controllability. Think about it guys. Now I will tell you better what is the classification. You have controllable and uncontrollable cost. Controllable and uncontrollable cost. I am going to explain guys, but then you think about it for a minute, better 10 seconds, 20 seconds better, and try to guess better as to what can be controllable and uncontrollable cost. Has to be pretty simple guys, cannot be complicated. This has to be pretty simple as such, better this cannot be complicated. You tell me guys, what has to be what should be controllable and uncontrollable cost. Now guys, majority of people guys, had this been a live class, majority of people beta would have answered, sir, anything that is controllable is controllable cost, anything that is not controllable is an uncontrollable cost. Correct beta, whatever you're thinking is perfectly right as such guys. Anything that is controllable has to be controllable, anything that is not controllable has to be uncontrollable cost. But guys, this classification of controllability is not from the viewpoint of the organization. Please understand guys, in the long run, from the viewpoint of organization, every cost element is controllable. From the viewpoint of the entire organization as such beta, every cost element will be controllable in the long run. Now this classification beta is from the viewpoint of a particular responsibility center or a particular department, particular division, particular person. Say guys, you are operating production department, you are operating a particular production department. Say there are 10 production departments as such guys, you are operating production department 1. Now, what the organization is doing better is, apart from the expenses that are being incurred in your particular department, you're also being given a share of common electricity expenditure. You are being given a share of common rent that is being incurred. You are being given a share of factory rent. You are being given a share of common expenditure that is incurred as such, guys. Now, as the head of the particular production department, beta, you can only control those expenses that are incurred within your department. Now, in your total cost, when they are computing the total cost of production department one, guys, they are not only including those expenses that are being incurred in your organization, in your department, but they are also including a share of these other expenses. But don't you think, beta, that those expenses are uncontrollable as far as you are concerned? You do not have the right, or you do not have the power, beta, to influence that expenditure. You are simply being given a share of that expenditure. ये अपन वापस सीए फाइनल में पढ़ेंगे बेटा, इन परफॉर्मेंस मेजरमेंट एंड एवैल्यूएशन, वेर इट क्लियरली सेज, सर इफ यू वांट टू इवैल्यूएट द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ एनी डिविजनल मैनेजर, इफ यू वांट टू इवैल्यूएट द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ एनी प्रोडक्शन मैनेजर, लेट दैट बी बेस्ड ऑन कंट्रोलेबल कॉस्ट. डू नॉट टेक अनकंट्रोलेबल फैक्टर्स इनटू कंसिडरेशन. हाउ कैन यू इवैल्यूएट द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ समवन बेटा बेस्ड ऑन समथिंग दैट इज नॉट विद इन हिज कंट्रोल. तो ये बाद में रेलेवेंट है बेटा, बट उसका डेफिनेशन यहाँ पे है. Irony of life, guys. All of this beta is covered in CA final also, but the definition is covered here. We will not have too many things related to controllable, uncontrollable as a part of CA intermediate syllabus. ठीक है? Right now, guys, I'm telling you again, when you use the word controllability as such, beta, this is not from the viewpoint of the entire organization. This is from the viewpoint of a particular responsibility center. It can be any department, any division, any person. Now, usually it may happen within an organization that while arriving at the total cost of a particular responsibility center, guys, specific expenses plus share of common expenses are also given. Now, this share of common expenses, beta, will become uncontrollable cost. Or say, for example, as such, guys, you are the production manager as such, beta, you are manufacturing a product. You are manufacturing a product as such, guys. You end up using more material. I come and question you. गला पकड़ने वाला था मैं, बट हाँ, आई कम एंड क्वेश्चन यू एज सच गाइस. आई कम एंड टेल यू व्हाई आर यू यूजिंग मोर मटेरियल, एंड देन यू पॉइंट आउट द रियल रीजन टू मी. सर, गो एंड क्वेश्चन परचेज मैनेजर. दैट फेलो इज परचेजिंग यूजलेस क्वालिटी ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल दैट वी हैव टू कंज्यूम मोर रॉ मटेरियल हियर. इट इज नो फॉल्ट ऑफ आर्स दैट वी आर डूइंग दिस. इट इज ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ सच, यू नो, सब स्टैंडर्ड रॉ मटेरियल बींग परचेस्ड. पॉसिबल गाइस? सोचो बेटा, multiple reasons as to why will we want classification of things beta into controllable and uncontrollable from the viewpoint of a particular person. It would help in informed decision making, in better decision making. I hope you have all understood this, guys. Write down beta your side reading, likho based on controllability. I will start dictating. Write the side reading beta based on controllability. I will start dictating. Controllable and uncontrollable cost bolke likho. Write the side heading beta and write this controllable and uncontrollable cost. Controllable and uncontrollable cost. Controllable and uncontrollable cost. Fill likho guys. From the viewpoint of the entire organization, all cost elements can be controlled in the long run. From the viewpoint of the entire organization, all cost elements can be controlled in the long run. This classification is from the viewpoint of a particular responsibility center. This classification is from the viewpoint of a particular responsibility center, a particular division, or a particular manager. Usually the total cost of a particular center, usually the total cost for a particular center, Usually, the total cost of a particular center will not only include specific expenses, will not only include specific expenses, but also share of common expenses. Factory rent allocated to production department. Factory rent allocated to production department to production department will be uncontrollable as far as production manager is concerned. I hope we have all understood better as to what is the classification of expenditure better based on controllability. Okay. I'm also happy guys, so many of you are asking doubts. So many messages, but then thode doubts Zoom sessions ke liye bhi rakho beta. Itne sare personal messages kar dete ho. Theek hai. Anyways, beta, based on controllability, beta, we are done. Now write the next heading as such guys, based on decision making. Write the next heading, beta, based on decision making. This will also include beta other cost concepts. All other cost concepts beta that I wanted to talk about. Cost concepts. The first one beta here, all of you beta write this heading, based on decision making. The first one beta here is relevant and irrelevant cost. Write down guys, all of you, based on decision making guys, other cost concepts, and write better first point as relevant and irrelevant cost. Now guys, this concept beta is again covered in detail as a part of CA final syllabus. But theek hai, padhane ki aadat hai, padha dunga. You will also see beta the concept of relevance and irrelevance in one chapter of financial management, and in few chapters of costing beta you might come across this concept as such beta, that will be useful for you to classify expenses. Remember guys, I am talking about relevant and irrelevant costs from the viewpoint of a particular decision. I am taking some decision as such guys, I want to understand as to whether a particular cost element would be relevant or would be irrelevant as such beta for that particular decision. For the purpose of decision making, whether a particular cost element as such beta would be relevant or irrelevant as such guys. Kya bol rahe ho sir? Suno beta. Say guys, you have decided that you will take up CA intermediate. Okay, you've cleared foundation, you have decided that you will take up CA intermediate. You are in the planning of deciding where should you be joining classes. You are still planning as such beta as to where should you be joining classes. That is the decision that you are yet to take. Okay, that's in the process as such guys. Tumhara CA inter, CA foundation ho chuka hai. You will do CA intermediate. Now guys, whether you join one institution or whether you join the other institution, whether you join one academy or whether you join the other academy as such guys, remember, you will still have to pay registration fees to ICAI. Irrespective of academy one or irrespective of academy two as such guys, I will still have to pay registration fees to ICAI. Such registration fees is irrelevant as far as my decision of academy is concerned. Perfect, sir. Understood. You are telling us that this is not going to change irrespective of the decision taking, and hence it is irrelevant for decision making. Understood. Let me change the example, guys. What if, beta? What if you have cleared your CA foundation? You are now thinking whether you should continue this course or not. You have cleared your CA foundation, beta, and now you have got thoughts about this course and you are wondering whether you should continue this course or not. ठीक है? So now the fees that is payable to ICAI, beta, would become relevant for decision making. What is the relevant? Should we continue with CA Inter? Should I take up CA Inter? If I take up CA Inter, I will pay fees to ICAI. If I do not take up CA Inter, I will not pay fees to ICAI. So yes, the fees payable to ICAI, beta, would become relevant for your decision making. Sir, kya baat kar rahe ho, sir? For education, why will we take all of this? Of course, beta, I'm just giving you an example. You can apply the same principle, beta, for business cost elements and, you know, get the same logic there. To samajhne ki koshish karo. You have cleared CA foundation as such, guys, or you have paid foundation fees. Theek hai? Or let us take another example, beta. Say you did not clear CA foundation. You did not clear CA foundation as such, beta. You are now deciding whether you should write the examination again. Theek hai? Should you continue the course and should you be writing the examination again? I repeat, beta, should you be taking up this course or should you be writing the examination again is what thought that you have in your mind. You have already paid registration fees for CA foundation, beta, to ICAI. Sunk cost, not relevant for decision making. Irrespective of whether you continue with the course or not, beta, remember the fees that is paid to ICAI for registration, guys, the fees that you paid for coaching as such, beta, is sunk cost, not relevant for decision making. Sunk cost, beta, is historical cost. So I hope you're trying to get better. There are two basic questions that you should be asking yourself, beta. There are two basic questions that you should be asking yourself, guys, in order to decide whether a particular cost element is relevant or irrelevant. There are two basic questions as such, guys, that you should be asking yourself to decide whether a particular cost element is relevant or irrelevant. First question, sir. Will the cost be incurred in the future? In brackets, it should not be a sunk cost. If it is sunk cost, it is irrelevant for decision making, beta. If it is historical or sunk cost, beta, it is irrelevant for decision making. So the question that you're asking yourself, beta, is will the cost be incurred in future? Am I going to incur this on a later date or is this something that is already incurred? If this is something that is already incurred, full stop lagao, it is not relevant for decision making. If this is something that will be incurred in the future as such, beta, then yes, you might go to the next question. Second question. Will it differ among different alternatives or will it remain same among different alternatives? Is it going to change based on my decision or is it going to remain constant? If it is going to remain constant, beta, irrespective of the decision that you have taken, it is irrelevant for decision making. If it is going to remain same irrespective of the decision that you have taken, beta, it is irrelevant for decision making. Only if it is going to change based on the decision that you have taken as such, beta, it would become relevant for decision making. So there are two simple questions as such, guys. Relevant, beta, only if. Please understand, guys. Relevant, beta, only if it is to be incurred on a later date. It is to be incurred on a later date. It is to be incurred on a later date, beta. It is not sunk or historical cost. It is not sunk or historical cost. It should be incurred on a later date as such, guys. Second part, beta, here is it should differ among different alternatives. It should differ among different alternatives. When I say it should differ among different alternatives as such, guys, it should not remain same. It should change based on the decision taken. It should change based on the decision taken. Only then it will be relevant, guys. Only if these two conditions are satisfied as such, beta, something will be relevant for decision making. Something would be relevant for decision making. Ab socho, beta, go back to the example that I gave, guys. You are sure that you will take up CA intermediate as such, beta. You are planning regarding which academy is to be taken up as such, guys. See, remember, guys, what if you are decision, guys? Sun lo, beta. Decision, guys, is which academy to join for CA Inter? Which academy to join? Okay, guys. Fees payable to ICAI. Irrelevant for decision making. irrelevant for decision making. The fees that is payable to ICAI beta is irrelevant for decision making. Sir, why is it irrelevant for decision making, guys? Irrespective of the academy, it is payable. It is incurred on a later date, guys. It is incurred on a later date as such, but no doubt about it as such, guys. Sir, why are you giving this example? Beta, you can better relate to it. This is something that has just happened in your lives now. Nice, sir. I will change the decision. Decision, beta, is should we continue with CA Inter? Should we continue with CA Inter? See, guys, you have changed your decision, beta, and now you're thinking as to whether you should continue with CA Inter. Fees payable to ICAI is relevant. Fees payable to ICAI is relevant. Someone is continuously calling, guys. Fees payable to ICAI beta will be absolutely relevant as such, guys, because obviously you will pay fees as such, guys, only if you decide to continue with CA Inter. Say, guys, decision. Should we write foundation exam again? Should we write foundation exams again? Foundation exams again. Registration fees paid to ICAI is sunk cost. Registration fees paid to ICAI is sunk cost. Sunk cost as such, guys, and not relevant. And not relevant. The registration fees, beta, that you paid to ICAI already, beta, for CA Foundation. For foundation is sunk cost and not relevant. What will be relevant, beta, here? Exam fees, beta, will be relevant. Exam fees will be relevant. This is what you should know, guys. I hope you all understood better. You have to decide based on anything, beta, that has already been incurred, any sunk cost as such, beta, any cost element incurred in the past is always irrelevant. Any cost already incurred as such, beta, is sunk cost and never relevant for decision making. I'm just trying to tell you, beta. Remember, guys, it should be something that is changing based on the decision that you take. Only then, beta, it will be relevant for decision making. Otherwise, how will it be relevant for decision making? Samajh gaye, sir? To ye copy karo, beta. Abhi aise bahut hai, beta, iske niche. Abhi to ye first shuruaat hai, bas. We have just started, guys. Copy karo, beta. You are supposed to copy this, guys. Yes, guys. make a note of this. फटाफट कॉपी करो बेटा. मेक अ क्विक नोट ऑफ इट. कॉपी करो बेटा. आर यू ऑल डन कॉपिंग दिस? हो गया क्या बच्चों सबका ये? येस बेटा, आई एम अज्यूमिंग दैट यू आर ऑल डन विद इट. द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट गाइस, दिस इज गाइस एक्चुअली बेटा बेस्ड ऑन डिसीजन मेकिंग. वी हैव ओनली टू कॉस्ट बेटा, रेलेवेंट एंड इररेलेवेंट कॉस्ट. बट देन देर आर मल्टीपल अदर कॉस्ट एलिमेंट्स गाइस, दैट इज दैट आई एम गोइंग टू कवर हियर बेटा. सो द नेक्स्ट वर्ड बेटा दैट वी आर गोइंग टू यूज इज मार्जिनल कॉस्ट. आई एम प्रेटी श्योर गाइज एवरी वन नोज वॉट इज मार्जिनल कॉस्ट, बिकॉज यू मस्ट हैव कम अक्रॉस दिस वर्ड गाइज इन इकोनॉमिक्स ऑल्सो. यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड बेटा अबाउट दिस इन इकोनॉमिक्स ऑल्सो गाइज. Marginal cost beta is nothing but the net increase in cost as such guys on account of one unit change in production. Marginal cost beta is nothing but the incremental cost incurred on account of a unit change in production. A unit change in production guys. Sir, can we say marginal cost is variable cost? Undoubtedly beta, marginal cost is nothing but the variable cost of a product. Undoubtedly guys, marginal cost is nothing but variable cost. Obviously beta, if you change your production by one unit, what is going to change? फिक्स कॉस्ट तो चेंज होगा नहीं बेटा. तो इट इज द अमाउंट ऑफ मार्जिनल कॉस्ट बेटा दैट इज गोइंग टू चेंज. ठीक है. लाइक वाइज बेटा वी हैव समथिंग कॉल्ड एज डिफरेंशियल कॉस्ट. लाइक मार्जिनल कॉस्ट बेटा वी हैव डिफरेंशियल कॉस्ट. नाउ दिस यू शुड नो बेटा. डिफरेंशियल कॉस्ट बेटा इज ये मार्जिनल कॉस्ट क्या बोला बेटा मैं? इंक्रीमेंटल कॉस्ट इंकर्ड. इंक्रीमेंटल कॉस्ट इंकर्ड ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ अ यूनिट चेंज इन प्रोडक्शन. ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ अ यूनिट चेंज इन एक्टिविटी. Unit change in activity. Okay. You can always say beta that marginal cost is variable cost. Marginal cost beta is variable cost. Differential cost ka matlab kya hota hai beta? Differential cost beta is basically change in total cost. Change in total cost. On account of either change in production level as such guys. On account of change in technology, change in total cost beta on account of, you know, change in activity, the total production as such guys, or change in technology. It can be change in activity beta, change in technology, production process, jo bhi hai beta. It is the net increase or decrease in cost, production process, or so on beta. basically guys, that is the net increase or decrease in cost as such, guys. Say guys, I am shifting from technology A to technology B. You are shifting from technology A beta to technology B, or you're shifting from process X to process Y. Process X to process Y, or you're shifting from say 1 lakh units as such beta to say 1 lakh 20,000 units. Whatever is the change in total cost beta here, change in total cost, that itself beta will be your differential cost. Whatever is the change in total cost that you're incurring as such beta itself will be differential cost. So remember beta, marginal cost kya beta, for one unit change in activity as such beta, what is the change in cost, that is marginal cost. So marginal cost beta will be equal to your variable cost. Differential cost beta is change in total cost on account of change in activity level, on account of change in production process, on account of change in technology. I hope you're all clear about this, guys. You can make a note of this beta, marginal cost and differential cost. Fatafat copy karo beta, let us not waste much time in copying, guys. I'll give you 1 minute to copy the entire thing. An additional 1 minute is bonus. Khado, copy karo. All of you guys copy. Write both beta marginal cost and differential cost in your notes. I hope you're all listening to the explanation also, guys. I hope you're all listening to the explanation beta and not merely copying. Okay beta, that's almost 2 minutes given to you. Sabka ho gaya kya ye? Are you all done? Theek hai beta, agar nahi hua to abhi pause kar lo. It's a simple thing, marginal cost and differential cost. Now beta, moving on to the next part is period cost and product cost. Period cost beta and product cost. Ab ye kya hai sir? Now guys, any cost element that is included in the valuation of inventory, any cost element beta that is included in the valuation of inventory as such, guys, is termed as a product cost. Usually beta, they're all manufacturing expenses. So any cost element that is included in the valuation of inventory as such beta is termed as a product cost. Try recollecting beta, you must have valued inventory at multiple places beta, even in consignment accounts as such, guys. When consigner is sending goods to consignee, whatever expenses beta that the consigner has incurred in transporting those goods to consignee beta, you must have included in valuation of inventory at consignee's location. Obviously beta, it is incurred to bring the inventory to the present location and condition. So whatever expenses beta that are eligible for to include them in the valuation of inventory are called as product cost. Expenses beta that cannot form part of valuation of inventory and should be directly transferred to profit and loss account, guys, are termed as period cost. Sir, ye to bahut simple hai na sir, can we directly say manufacturing expenses are product cost, selling and distribution cost are period cost, because selling and distribution cost will always go to profit and loss account. Can we say administrative cost beta is period cost? No doubt about it beta, that selling and distribution cost, administrative cost are period cost, because they will be transferred to profit and loss account and they will not form part of inventory valuation. But later guys, in this subject we will be learning about techniques of costing. later beta in this subject beta we will be learning about techniques of costing. Those techniques beta will tell us as to what is to be included, what is to be excluded beta from the valuation of inventory. Those techniques beta will tell us what is to be included, what is to be excluded beta from the valuation of inventory. ठीक है. So there are different techniques beta. वहाँ पे not all manufacturing expenses will form part of inventory valuation. अभी के लिए इतना समझो beta. You do not have to worry about those techniques of costings. As of now understand beta that yes, anything that is forming part of inventory valuation is a product cost. Anything that does not form part of a valuation of inventory beta is a period cost. I hope it is very clear as such guys. Selling and distribution expenditure beta, office and administrative cost obviously guys would be period cost. Obviously beta would be period cost because they do not form part of your inventory valuation. They do not form part of your inventory valuation. Make a note of it guys. Fourth point bolke likho dictate karta hu. Period cost and product cost. Right guys, fourth point I'll dictate period cost and product cost. Period cost and product cost. Write the fourth point beta, period cost and product cost. Right on. All cost elements that form part of valuation of inventory. All cost elements that form part of valuation of inventory are termed as product cost. Example, manufacturing expenses. Next, all cost elements that cannot be included in valuation of inventory. All cost elements that cannot be included in valuation of inventory and are directly transferred to profit and loss account are termed as period cost. Example, selling and distribution expenses. ठीक है बेटा. The next point beta is opportunity cost. Sir, rehne do sir, we know about this. Udlen sir, maaku chaala manchiga vastadi mem cheskuntamu. What do you know re? Opportunity cost beta is nothing but the cost of the sacrifice that you are making in life. It is the cost of the next best alternative. Remember guys, opportunity cost concept arises only if you have more than one alternative. ठीक है. Only if there is more than one alternative as such beta, the concept of opportunity cost arises. If there is only one alternative as such beta, where is the question of opportunity cost? Where is the question of opportunity cost as such guys? ठीक है. With great difficulty as such beta, say Nimit ke liye ek rishta aata hai. ठीक है. He is trying to compute what is the opportunity cost here guys. Where is the opportunity cost? There is only one rishta now there. No opportunity cost for this fellow guys. Nothing at all as such beta. So understand guys, the question of opportunity cost will arise beta only when you have more than one alternative as such guys. More than one alternative. Say guys, you qualify this course as such beta, you become a chartered accountant as such guys. That is bound to happen after 3 years, after 4 years from now. So you become a chartered accountant as such guys. After becoming a CA as such guys, you decide to get into practice. You decide that you will not be taking up a job. So if you get into practice as such guys, the amount of salary income that you forego becomes your opportunity cost. If you are using your own premises as such beta for the purpose of your business, the amount of rental income that you have foregone is your opportunity cost. Please understand guys. वैसे ही बेटा सबको आता है मेरे को मालूम है बेटा. वैसे दे समथिंग कॉल्ड एज संक कॉस्ट आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन बेटा. इट इज समथिंग दैट इज ऑलरेडी इंकर्ड सच गाइस. इज संक कॉस्ट लिख लो बेटा सब लोग. अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट है सच गाइस. ऑल ऑफ यू बेटा राइट नेक्स्ट पार्ट अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट. ये अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट बेटा संक कॉस्ट दे कम अ लॉट इन द एग्जामिनेशन. आई डू नॉट नो व्हाई गाइस. बहुत बार आते as theory questions as such, guys, they come a lot in the examination. But an opportunity cost is the cost of the next best alternative. Opportunity cost is the cost of the next best alternative. Opportunity cost is the cost of the next best alternative, or the sacrifice being made, or the sacrifice being made. Opportunity cost is the cost of the next best alternative, or the sacrifice being made. The sacrifice being made. It arises only when there is more than one alternative. It arises only when there is more than one alternative. It arises only when there is more than one alternative. It arises only when there is more than one alternative. More than one alternative. Arises only when there is more than one alternative. Example. Example. The amount of salary foregone by a chartered accountant. The amount of salary foregone by a CA if he starts his own practice. The amount of salary foregone by a CA if he starts his own practice. If he starts his own practice. The amount of salary foregone by a CA if he starts his own practice. If he starts his own practice. Amount of salary foregone by a CA if he starts his own practice. Starts his own practice. इससे याद आया बेटा, मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स बेटा सी ए इंटर स्टूडेंट्स गाइज क्लियर फ्रॉम आर सी ए, मेजॉरिटी ऑफ देम बेटा गेट प्लेस्ड इन यू नो बिग फोर्स. इट सो फार बेटा एज आई एम रिकॉर्डिंग दिस क्लास, ई वाई में बेटा, हैदराबाद ई वाई में बेटा ऑलमोस्ट एवरी स्टूडेंट सच बेटा दैट हैज बीन सेलेक्टेड इज फ्रॉम आर सी ए. देन बेटा अदर गुड फॉर्म्स ऑल्सो सच गाइज, वेर एवर देर आर ऑल द गुड फॉर्म्स सच बेटा, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी, आई एम वेरी प्राउड सच बेटा टू से दैट येस मेजॉरिटी ऑफ देम आर फ्रॉम आर सी ए. What happens, beta? Immediately after your examinations, beta, I keep following up with all of these. Me, Ankita, beta, especially. Ankita, especially, of course. We keep following up as such, beta, with all of these forms as such, guys, to ensure, you know, that your interviews are taken place at the right time. You know, your interviews are taken well in hand as such, guys. So that you do not have to worry about your internship. So, okay. It's a proud thing as such, beta, for me that all the students are placed in good forms as such, guys. They get to work in good working cultures. ओके बेटा हो गया भाषण हो गया. सिक्स पॉइंट बेटा संक कॉस्ट. राइट ऑन बेटा संक कॉस्ट. संक कॉस्ट. राइट ऑन बेटा संक कॉस्ट. संक कॉस्ट. संक कॉस्ट इज अ कॉस्ट एलिमेंट व्हिच इज ऑलरेडी इंकर्ड. संक कॉस्ट इज कॉस्ट एलिमेंट व्हिच इज ऑलरेडी इंकर्ड. संक कॉस्ट इज अ कॉस्ट एलिमेंट व्हिच इज ऑलरेडी इंकर्ड. Sunk cost is a cost element which is already incurred. Already incurred. Cost element beta which is already incurred. Okay guys. Ha. Now beta the next concept beta is implicit cost, which is also known as imputed cost. Or beta they can be notional cost, or it can be termed as economic cost. बस करो सर. एंड बेटा और एक एक है एक्सप्लिसिट कॉस्ट विच कैन ऑल्सो बी टर्म्ड एज आउट ऑफ पॉकेट एक्सपेंडिचर. आउट ऑफ पॉकेट एक्सपेंडिचर. ठीक है सर बोलो आगे बोलो. अभी गाइस इम्प्लिसिट कॉस्ट और इम्प्यूटेड कॉस्ट यू हैव डन दिस ऑल्सो बेटा एज अ पार्ट ऑफ योर सीए फाउंडेशन इकोनॉमिक्स. यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड दिस वर्ड्स देयर फॉर श्योर सच गाइस. इम्प्लिसिट कॉस्ट बेटा और इम्प्यूटेड कॉस्ट इज समथिंग फॉर विच देयर इज नो आउटफ्लो ऑफ कैश. Implicit cost beta or imputed cost is something for which there will be no outflow of cash required as such guys. No outflow of cash is required beta for implicit cost or imputed cost. Theek hai. Economic cost beta, notional cost, they're all the same guys. Notional cost beta is basically the cost of using your own resources. To economic cost, isko hum log economic cost kyun bolte beta, because these are not accounted for in the books. These are not accounted for beta in the books. But however beta, in order to know the true profitability of any business concern, you're supposed to take this economic cost or imputed cost also into consideration. Accounting profit will not always portray the right picture as such guys. So in order to know the true profitability of an organization guys, I have to ensure that I take this economic cost also into consideration guys, and then arrive at the economic profit of the organization. इसके अलावा बेटा देर इज एक्सप्लिसिट कॉस्ट. एक्सप्लिसिट कॉस्ट आर दोज कॉस्ट दैट आर अकाउंटेड फॉर इन द बुक्स. बेसिकली दे रिजल्ट इन कैश आउटफ्लो. दे रिजल्ट बेटा इन कैश आउटफ्लो. आई रिपीट बेटा, एक्सप्लिसिट कॉस्ट आर बेसिकली दोज बेटा दैट आर अकाउंटेड फॉर इन द बुक्स एंड दे रिजल्ट इन कैश आउटफ्लो गाइस. दे डू रिजल्ट बेटा इन कैश आउटफ्लो. सर एग्जाम्पल बोलो सर, आप बहुत बोल रहे हो. Now guys, let me ask you a question. I hope you've understood till this point, guys. I just told you that implicit cost do not result in cash outflow. They are not accounted for in the books of accounts. Hence, they are economic cost. Cost of utilizing own resources, beta, is an implicit cost or an imputed cost. Explicit cost, on the other hand, beta, results in cash outflow and are accounted for in the books. I'll ask you a simple question but now, beta. You tell me what is the answer. Is depreciation an implicit cost or an explicit cost? Is depreciation, guys, an implicit cost or an explicit cost? What do you think, beta, depreciation is? Is depreciation implicit or is depreciation explicit cost? Usme kya sir, doubt hi nahi hai. It does not result in cash outflow and hence it has to be implicit. But sir, you account for it in the books of accounts, so it is explicit. Socho beta. I told you guys implicit cost are those that do not result in cash outflow. Implicit cost are those beta that do not result in cash outflow as such, guys, and they're not accounted for in the books of accounts. Explicit cost results in cash outflow and are accounted for in the books of accounts. So now I'm asking you beta, is depreciation an implicit cost or is depreciation an explicit cost? What will be your answer, guys? Is depreciation an implicit cost or is depreciation an explicit cost? Sir, simple is sir. इसमें तो कुछ doubt ही नहीं रहना चाहिए. क्या है बेटा वो? Sir, depreciation does not result in cash outflow, sir. So it is implicit cost. But depreciation is accounted for in the books of accounts. So it is explicit cost. नहीं बेटा. Tell me the right answer to it, guys. Is it implicit or is it explicit? एक बात करो बेटा. दोनों बात नहीं करना है अपन को यहाँ पे. आप भी बोल दो सर अभी. इतना सब बोल दिए तो. Guys, depreciation is an explicit cost. Sir, wait, sir, what are you talking? Yes, beta, depreciation is an explicit cost. Do not forget, beta, the consideration that you have paid for the purchase of the asset, beta, itself is the cash outflow. The consideration that you have paid, beta, for the purchase of the asset, guys, itself is a cash outflow, guys. I repeat, the consideration that you have paid for the purchase of the asset, beta, is the cash outflow for this asset. Is the cash outflow, beta. This is what you will have to understand. Asset kharide jab kuch na kuch to paisa diye honge na, beta. So whatever amount, whatever consideration that you have paid, beta, to buy that asset itself will be the cash outflow, guys, that you will have to consider for this. And hence depreciation is considered as an explicit cost and not an implicit cost. But obvious, guys, whatever is appearing in your books of accounts might have resulted in cash outflow, if not now, beta, at some point of time. Anything that is appearing in your books of accounts as such, guys, might have resulted in cash outflow, beta, if not now, at some point of time. Yes or no? So doubt kahan se aaya, beta, usme apan ko fir. समझ में आ रहा है नहीं आ रहा है? हाँ सर आ गया समझ में, तो लिख लो बेटा अभी. राइट डाउन गाइस, ऑल ऑफ यू बेटा राइट डाउन इम्प्लिसिट कॉस्ट. ऑल ऑफ यू बेटा राइट डाउन इम्प्लिसिट कॉस्ट. इम्प्लिसिट कॉस्ट. ये पूरा लिखो बेटा, इम्प्लिसिट और इम्प्यूटेड और नोशनल और इकोनॉमिक कॉस्ट. इम्प्लिसिट और इम्प्यूटेड बेटा और नोशनल और इकोनॉमिक कॉस्ट. एंड फिर लिखो गाइस, द कॉस्ट एलिमेंट्स दैट डू नॉट रिजल्ट इन कैश आउटफ्लो. द कॉस्ट एलिमेंट्स दैट डू नॉट रिजल्ट इन कैश आउटफ्लो एंड आर नॉट अकाउंटेड फॉर इन द बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स. द कॉस्ट एलिमेंट्स दैट डू नॉट रिजल्ट इन कैश आउटफ्लो. The cost elements that do not result in cash outflow and are not accounted for in the books of accounts. And are not accounted for in the books of accounts. The cost elements that do not result in cash outflow and are not accounted for in the books of accounts. And are not accounted for in the books of accounts. Not accounted for in the books of accounts. They are the cost of using own resources. 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 Example, rent on own premises, interest on own capital. 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 Interest on own capital. Rent of own premises, beta, interest on own capital. Next, guys. Explicit cost or out of pocket cost. 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 Write down better. These cost elements results in cash outflow. These cost elements results in cash outflow. These cost elements results in cash outflow. These cost elements result in cash outflow. These cost elements result in cash outflow and are accounted for in the books of accounts. And are accounted for in the books of accounts. And are accounted for in the books of accounts. And are accounted for in the books of accounts. Example, raw material purchased, wages paid. Raw material purchased, wages paid. Raw material purchased, wages paid. Wages paid. Wages paid. Next, guys. वहीं पे continuation लिखो. Depreciation is an explicit cost. 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 The consideration paid for purchase of a set. The consideration paid for purchase of a set is a cash outflow. The consideration paid for purchase of a set is a cash outflow. The consideration paid for purchase of a set is a cash outflow. Consideration paid for purchase of a set is a cash outflow. Is the cash outflow. Samajh gaye, sir. So this is about implicit cost, imputed cost, notional cost, out-of-pocket cost, explicit cost, guys. Next, beta, write down capitalized cost. Yes, simple hai, beta. The expenses, beta, which qualified to be shown as assets in the books of accounts. Capitalized cost matlab kya, guys? Basically, property, plant and equipment. Property, plant and equipment, guys. Basically, guys, fixed assets. Property, plant and equipment, beta. Fixed assets. When you say, beta, capitalized, it means, beta, the word capitalize as such, guys, basically means, beta, that expenditure is shown as asset. Expenditure is shown as asset in books of accounts. Expenditure is shown as a set in books of accounts. It is not transferred to profit and loss account, beta. It is capitalized. It is added to the cost of an asset. So capitalized cost, beta, is basically your investment, beta. Something that will give you future economic benefits as such, guys. The expenditure that is going to give you a lot of future economic benefits as such, guys, and is resulting in the creation of an asset. So that is capitalized cost. Okay. Samajh mein aa gaya honga, beta. Normal hai beta, kuch hai nahi yahan pe tera. Guys, a lot of definitions are pretty simple as such, guys. For that, you will not need any further, preparation as such, guys. Now, this is something beta that you might forget. Engineered cost. This is something beta that you will have to remember because people generally forget this as such, guys. Engineered cost ka matlab hota hai beta. There's a clear cause and effect relationship beta between inputs and outputs. There is clear cause and effect relationship beta between inputs and outputs. There has to be a clear cause and effect relationship between input and output. Matlab kya, sir? Between inputs and outputs. Say, guys, to manufacture one unit, I need 10 kgs of raw material. To manufacture one unit, I need 10 kgs of raw material. So, yes, there's a clear cut cost. This is input beta. I would say this is engineered cost. engineered cost. It is clearly defined as such, but you know that to get this output as such, guys, you will need 10 kgs of material. There's a clear cause and effect relationship. If I use 1000 kgs of material, I should get an output of 100 units. To produce 100 units, I will be needing 100 hours of work. I will need this machinery beta for 2 hours. I will be needing so much of electricity consumption. So if there's a clear cut cause and effect relationship beta between inputs and outputs as such, guys, then that, yes, thus expenditure as such beta would be defined as your engineered cost. गाइस जो भी बेटा तुम्हारा एक्सपेंडिचर का लिस्ट बनता है टू मैन्युफैक्चर अ प्रोडक्ट अ सर्च गाइस द डिजाइन टीम जो तुम्हारे को देता है द डिजाइन टीम बेटा विल ऑब्वियसली गिव यू अ स्टेटमेंट अ सर्च गाइस एंड देन टेल यू बेटा दैट यू विल हैव टू प्रिपेयर ऑल ऑफ दिस एंड दैट बेटा वुड बिकम योर इंजीनियर्ड कॉस्ट अ सर्च गाइस नाउ यू विल कॉपी बोथ ऑफ देम बेटा कैपिटलाइज कॉस्ट एंड इंजीनियर्ड कॉस्ट नोटबुक्स में लिखो गाइस नोटबुक्स में सब लोग लिखो बेटा कैपिटलाइज्ड कॉस्ट और ये यस बेटा Yes, guys. I hope you're all done with this. बहुत ज़्यादा time दे दिया. Now let us move to the next concept, guys, and that is discretionary cost and committed cost. Discretionary बेटा and committed cost. अब ये क्या है सर? It may happen बेटा that few expenses you've already entered into contracts as such, guys. You've already entered into agreements. You cannot do anything about it as such, बेटा in the short run. So we would say बेटा that those expenses are committed cost. Those expenses beta would become committed cost as such beta discretionary cost as such beta is at your discretion at your option you haven't entered into any agreements the amount of advertisement expenditure that an organization will incur beta is a discretionary cost the amount of research and development expenditure that they will enter beta is that they will incur beta is discretionary cost at the discretion of the organization when I say at the discretion of the organization beta it is at their option At the discretion of the organization as such, guys. So this would be better say advertisement expenditure, research and development expenditure, guys. Committed cost as such, better agreements are already entered into. Agreements are entered into. Agreements are entered into as such, guys. Expenditure cannot be avoided. Expenditure cannot be avoided. Expenditure cannot be avoided as such, guys. You have already entered into agreement, beta. There is no way that you avoid that expenditure as such, guys. Say, beta, example, factory rent. Factory rent. अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस इज सच गाइस बिटवीन डिस्क्रिशनरी कॉस्ट एंड कमिटेड कॉस्ट. गाइज अभी कोई बोला सर रॉ मटेरियल वेजेस मार्क डालूंगा बेटा. इफ यू वांट टू रन योर बिजनेस ऑब्वियसली यू हैव टू इनकर ऑल ऑफ दोज एक्सपेंसेस गाइज. इफ यू हैव टू रन योर बिजनेस बेटा नो मैटर व्हाट हैपेंस गाइज यू हैव टू इनकर रॉ मटेरियल कॉस्ट यू हैव टू इनकर मटेरियल कॉस्ट एज सच गाइज. सो डिस्क्रिशनरी कॉस्ट एज सच बेटा एंड कमिटेड कॉस्ट. डिस्क्रिशनरी कॉस्ट इज एट द डिस्क्रिशन ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. आई जस्ट गिव एन एग्जांपल ऑफ एडवर्टाइजमेंट कॉस्ट आर एंड डी कॉस्ट एज सच गाइज. नेक्स्ट बेटा नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट बेटा हियर यू आई विल गिव यू टाइम टू कॉपी डिस्क्रिशनरी एंड कमिटेड कॉस्ट ऑल्सो. छोटे छोटे टर्मिनोलॉजी से बेटा छोटे छोटे वर्ड्स आई एम ट्राइंग जस्ट टू एक्सप्लेन ऑल ऑफ देम. टुमारो डोंट वरी गाइस आई स्टार्ट मटेरियल चैप्टर इज सच बेटा प्रैक्टिकल एस्पेक्ट भी आ जाएगा. सो नाउ गाइस आफ्टर दिस बेटा इज से यू हैव समथिंग कॉल्ड एज प्री डिटरमाइंड कॉस्ट स्टैंडर्ड कॉस्ट एस्टिमेटेड कॉस्ट प्रीडिटरमाइंड कॉस्ट बेटा स्टैंडर्ड कॉस्ट एंड एस्टिमेटेड कॉस्ट एज सच गाइस. नाउ व्हेन यू से प्रीडिटरमाइंड कॉस्ट एज सच गाइस व्हेन यू से प्रीडिटरमाइंड कॉस्ट एज सच बेटा हियर दिस बेसिकली मींस बेटा कॉस्ट इज एस्टिमेटेड और कॉस्ट इज डिटरमाइंड बिफोर प्रोडक्शन. कॉस्ट इज डिटरमाइंड बिफोर प्रोडक्शन एज सच बेटा प्रीडिटरमाइंड कॉस्ट कुछ भी नहीं है बेटा. कॉस्ट इज डिटरमाइंड बिफोर प्रोडक्शन गाइस वी हैव सेपरेट टॉपिक्स है सच बेटा. स्टैंडर्ड कॉस्टिंग बोल के एक सेपरेट टॉपिक आएगा बेटा वेयर आई विल बी टेलिंग यू व्हाट इज स्टैंडर्ड कॉस्ट. डोंट वरी गाइस नाउ बिकॉज वी हैव दिस टर्मिनोलॉजी बीइंग कवर्ड हियर आई एम कवरिंग अ मेजर पार्ट ऑफ इट बेटा. सम पार्ट ऑफ थ्योरी दैट इज लेफ्ट वी कैन डू इट लेटर. नाउ स्टैंडर्ड कॉस्ट बेटा इज प्री डिटरमाइंड कॉस्ट बेटा विथ अ रिक्वायर्ड लेवल ऑफ एफिशिएंसी. मतलब एट दिस एफिशिएंसी लेवल यू विल हैव टू ऑपरेट. आई विल हैव टू एंश्योर बेटा दैट माय लेबर मैन्युफैक्चर्स द प्रोडक्ट इन 30 मिनट्स फॉर विच माय कॉस्ट शुड बी सो मच. आई विल हैव टू एंश्योर बेटा दैट मटेरियल कंजम्पशन शुड बी ओनली 1 kg पर यूनिट फॉर विच द कॉस्ट शुड बी सो मच. समझ में आ रहा है बेटा. सो प्री डिटरमाइंड कॉस्ट बेटा विद द रिक्वायर्ड लेवल ऑफ एफिशिएंसी एज सच गाइस. सो सिर्फ बेटा फॉर एग्जांपल गाइस से स्टैंडर्ड टाइम इज 30 मिनट्स टू मैन्युफैक्चर अ प्रोडक्ट एंड स्टैंडर्ड वेज रेट एज सच बेटा इसे 100 rupees per hour एज सच गाइस. सो दिस विल बिकम अ स्टैंडर्ड कॉस्ट एज सच बेटा प्री डिटरमाइंड कॉस्ट विद द रिक्वायर्ड लेवल ऑफ एफिशिएंसी. एस्टिमेटेड कॉस्ट एज सच बेटा इज अ मियर एस्टिमेट एज सच गाइस. ठीक है मियर एस्टिमेट एज सच बेटा. नाउ यूजुअली बेटा फॉर न्यू ऑर्डर्स something that you have not done in the past as such beta for that we might use the word estimated cost. I hope you have understood both discretionary cost, committed cost beta as well as predetermined cost, standard cost beta and estimated cost. Make a note of this guys. All of you beta copy this. Ye copy karo beta discretionary cost and committed cost first beta and then copy 12th one. Copy this guys, all of you. यस बेटा। I hope you're all done with this, beta. If you're done, guys, I'll move on to the next part here. We just have few more cost elements as such, guys. Just a couple of more cost elements as such, beta, and then we'll be done with classification of expenses altogether, guys. We will be done with classification of expenses, guys. Just a few more cost expenses. Sabka ho gaya. Yes or no, guys? Okay, beta. Assuming that you're all done with it, beta. The next cost concept, beta, here is shutdown cost. Shutdown cost. Again, beta, this is something that you must have heard about it in economics as such, guys. Tum log shutdown pricing padhe honge, beta. Shutdown pricing is a price, market price, where it is above marginal cost of a product but below the total cost of a product. Aisa kuch padhe honge, beta. So guys, anyways, beta, shutdown cost is that cost element as such, guys, which will be incurred, which will continue to be incurred as such, guys, even if the premises are temporarily closed. Shutdown cost are those expenses as such, beta, that will be incurred even if the premises are temporarily closed as such, guys. Even if your premises as such, beta, are temporarily closed, shutdown cost will be incurred. Example kya? See, guys, what happens, beta, when the business conditions are not favorable as such, guys? I am not talking about a permanent closure. If you permanently close down the firm as such, guys, remember, all the cost elements can be avoided. If you are permanently shutting down the business as such, guys, undoubtedly all the cost elements can be avoided. I am talking about a temporary shutdown as such, guys. See, guys, many of the theaters were not operating as such, beta, for the last 7 months, 8 months. Many of the theaters were not operating as such, beta, for the last 7, 8 months. But they still had to pay, beta, some amount of salaries to their employees. It is not like, beta, they let go of all the employees. So that expenditure, beta, that you are continuing to incur even if you are shutting down your business, temporarily as such, beta, is called a shutdown cost. Classic examples, beta, for shutdown cost, beta, will be salary of key employees. You know, beta, that certain employees, there are certain experts as such, guys, you will not be able to hire them again. Say, beta, you have Uday Bhattad working for you. Theek hai? Uday Bhattad, beta, is one of the students of the class. Huh. Uday Bhattad working for you as such, guys. Say now, Uday Bhattad as such, beta, you know that you will not be able to find a gem like this, beta, ever again in your life. So you've decided, guys, that even if your business is temporarily shut down as such, beta, you will continue to pay him salary. You will continue to take his services as such, guys. Now the salary that is payable to Uday Bhattad, beta, is shutdown cost. The salary that is payable to Uday Bhattad, beta, is shutdown cost. Samajh mein aa raha hai Uday? I hope you're understanding. Theek hai, beta? So this is what you'll have to understand, beta, by shutdown cost. So we have understood as to what is shutdown cost as such, guys. Now the next shutdown cost, beta. Other example, beta, will be factory rent. So even if I'm shutting down my factory temporarily as such, beta, it is not that I will take all the machinery, put it outside as such, beta, outside the factory. You might have to incur factory rent also as such, guys. Even that will be considered as your shutdown cost. Even that will be considered, beta, as shutdown cost. So yes, beta, shutdown cost is something that those cost elements, beta, that are incurred even if the premises are temporarily shut. We will be discussing shutdown cost in detail, beta, under marginal costing. we would be discussing shutdown cost beta in detail under marginal costing as such, guys. There's a chapter called as marginal costing later. वहाँ पे shutdown cost आएगा, ठीक है? सब लोग लिख लो बेटा shutdown cost. I hope you have understood shutdown cost beta properly. Write down the cost elements which are incurred even if the premises are temporarily closed. The cost elements that are incurred even if the premises are temporarily closed. The cost elements that are incurred even if the premises are temporarily closed. Even if the premises are temporarily closed. Even if the premises are temporarily, premises मतलब the business is temporarily closed. Business is temporarily closed. Example guys, salary of key employees, factory rent. Salary of key employees, factory rent. Salary of key employees, factory rent. Salary of key employees as such beta and factory rent. Factory rent. I understand beta बहुत ज़्यादा theory हो रहा है, but सुन लो कुछ option नहीं है. Salary of key employees as such guys and factory rent. Next point beta, 14th one. 14th one as such guys, shutdown cost हो चुका है beta. So coming to the next part as such beta here is और क्या बच गया beta? Conversion cost. Conversion cost. Now the word conversion cost beta basically means cost of converting material into cost of converting materials into work in progress or finished products. Cost of converting materials beta into work in progress beta and or finished products. Basically guys, it is all manufacturing expenses except material cost. You are converting material beta into work in progress and finished expenses. So it is all manufacturing expenses except all manufacturing expenses beta except material cost. Except material cost beta will be conversion cost. All manufacturing expenses beta except material cost as such beta will be conversion cost. Or ek chota point hai beta, absolute cost bolke. Absolute cost is nothing but a total cost expressed in absolute terms. Total cost beta expressed in absolute terms. Whatever is the total cost, instead of expressing them in percentages as such, beta, they're expressed in absolute values, and that will be your absolute cost. Ho gaye beta. We are done with all the cost elements, guys. Khatam. All the classification of expenses is done, guys. Ye dono bhi likh lo beta. Then I will quickly revise all of this. Nakko sir, revision nakko. Likho beta ye conversion cost and absolute cost. All of you beta, write this conversion cost and absolute cost. Yes beta, I hope you are writing this conversion cost beta and this. Yes guys, are you all clear about this? Did you all make a note of it? Did we all make a note of it, guys? Conversion cost, absolute cost. ठीक है गाइस, आई होप यू ऑल रिटन इट एज सच गाइस. सो वी आर डन विद क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एक्सपेंसेस गाइस. जस्ट अ क्विक रीकैप गाइस, आई विल नॉट बी एक्सप्लेनिंग इन डिटेल अगेन, बट अंडर क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एक्सपेंसेस द फर्स्ट कैटेगरी बेटा वाज बेस्ड ऑन वेरिएबिलिटी, दैट इज इन रिलेशन टू आउटपुट. नाउ बेस्ड ऑन वेरिएबिलिटी बेटा, वी हैव क्लासिफाइड एक्सपेंसेस इनटू वेरिएबल एक्सपेंडिचर, फिक्स्ड एक्सपेंडिचर, सेमी वेरिएबल कॉस्ट बेटा एंड स्टेप फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट. Variable cost beta is one where your cost per unit beta will change, will cost per unit remains constant, total cost will change, fixed cost beta, total cost remains constant, cost per unit will change, semi-variable both will change, step fixed cost beta remains fixed for a particular level of activity after which it changes beta and again remains fixed beta for the next level of activity. After that beta we did segregation of semi-variable cost beta into variable and fixed. I said five methods: change in activity method, graphical method, analytical method, high-low method, simultaneous equations method. And then, beta, we moved on to classification of expenses, beta, based on functions, manufacturing expenditure, selling and distribution, administrative guys, research and development. Then we did, beta, based on normality of cost. We have normal cost and abnormal cost. We did elements of cost before that, material, labor, and other expenses. Under material also, we have direct material, indirect material, direct labor, indirect labor, direct expenses, indirect expenses. All direct costs put together, beta, are termed as prime cost. All indirect expenses put together, beta, is termed as overheads, are termed as overheads as such, guys. Direct expenses are those that can be directly identified with the product that is being manufactured or the service that is being rendered, beta. You can directly relate to it. And then, guys, after this, beta, we did based on controllability. I said controllable cost and uncontrollable cost. I said this is not from the viewpoint of the entire organization. It is from the viewpoint of the responsibility center. And then finally, beta, based on decision making, wherein we first did relevant and irrelevant. Anything, beta, that is incurred in the, that will be incurred in the future, guys, and will change among different alternatives will be relevant for decision making. Anything that is already incurred in the past as such, beta, will always be irrelevant for decision making, guys. After that, we did marginal cost, beta. It is a net increase in cost for every unit change in activity level. Differential cost is a change in total cost at two different levels of activities as such, guys. Product cost and period cost. Period cost are those, beta, that are directly transferred to profit and loss account and are not included in the valuation of inventory. Product cost are included in the valuation of inventory, guys. Opportunity cost is the cost of next best alternative or the sacrifice being made. Sunk cost is something that has already been incurred in the past. Implicit or imputed cost, beta, are those that do not result in any cash outflow as such, guys, and are not accounted for in the books of accounts. The cost of using our own resources. Explicit cost, beta, results in cash outflow, guys. They're accounted in the books of accounts. Capitalized cost, beta, are those that are shown as assets in the books of accounts. Engineered costs have a clear-cut cause and effect relationship, guys, between the inputs and the output. Discretionary cost, beta, is at the discretion of the organization, guys, and committed cost is for which agreements have already been entered into. Predetermined cost, beta, is cost computed before production. Standard cost is predetermined cost only, beta, but with a certain level of efficiency. And estimated cost, beta, is a mere estimate which we'll have for new orders. Shutdown cost are those costs as such, beta, that will be incurred even if the business is temporarily closed as such, guys, due to certain rules as such, but our economic activity is bad. Conversion cost is the cost of converting raw materials into finished products. Absolute cost is the total cost, beta, expressed in absolute terms. It is not that we are done with it, beta. Let us go to the first chapter. If you look at a majority of the questions as such, guys, as I said, beta, I'm re-recording this class, so you might see certain things, Majority of the theory questions, beta, at the end of every chapter, guys, I might have told you this yesterday also, at the end of every chapter, beta, you will have weightage. You will have weightage as such, guys. The most important theory, bare minimum, beta, the weightage of this chapter is 4 marks. Most important theory, beta, that they ask in the examination is classification of expenses, beta, and cost units or methods of costing and responsibility centers. Ye jo cost unit or methods of costing, beta, you will understand better after doing all the chapters, not now. So once we do all the chapters as such, guys, later, we will come back to this and answer, guys. We will come back to this and answer different cost units of different industries as such, guys, or the methods of costing. But yaad rakhna, beta, these are the most important questions. A list of all the previous examination questions is also given, beta. If you do not want to do all the questions, at least you can see the recent examination questions from May 2018 as such, guys, to get an idea as to what type of questions are coming in the examination, guys. So, ये लिख लेना बेटा मटेरियल में पेज 1.17 में बेटा यू कैन राइट दिस एज दीज आर द इंपॉर्टेंट मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थ्योरी क्वेश्चंस गाइस आर बेस्ड ऑन क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एक्सपेंसेस कॉस्ट यूनिट्स और मेथड्स ऑफ कॉस्टिंग गाइस एंड रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी सेंटर्स क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एक्सपेंसेस कॉस्ट यूनिट्स और मेथड्स ऑफ कॉस्टिंग गाइस एंड रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी सेंटर्स ठीक है प्लीज मेक अ नोट ऑफ दिस गाइस इन योर बुक्स पेज नंबर 1.17 Page 1.17, beta, make a note of it in your books. Samajh mein aa raha hai kya bol raha hu? Ek baar question number 15 dekho beta, wahi page pe. Question number 15, guys, on the same page. It is telling us interest paid on own capital, beta, not involving any cash outflow. When you're paying interest on your own capital as such, beta, it is an implicit cost or imputed cost. Interest paid on own capital. Answer is also given there, beta. Don't worry about it. But interest paid on own capital, beta, is an implicit or an imputed cost. withdrawing money beta from bank deposit for the purpose of purchasing machine. When you are withdrawing money beta from a bank deposit and you're purchasing a machine out of it as such, guys, it is obviously beta opportunity cost. It is undoubtedly beta opportunity cost. Samajh mein aa raha hai na? If you are withdrawing money beta from a bank and you're using that to invest in your business, it has to be opportunity cost. Rent paid for factory building which is temporarily closed. Shutdown cost, but obviously I've just explained this. The last one is important, beta. Cost associated with acquisition and conversion of material into finished product. Now this is not just conversion, beta. Yahan pe majority of them go wrong, beta. They might directly write conversion cost. Remember, beta, acquisition. It includes cost of material. Underline the word acquisition, beta, and write includes cost of material. Underline the word acquisition, beta, and write includes cost of material, guys. It includes cost of material. You are supposed to underline the word acquisition as such, beta, and write that this includes cost of material. This includes cost of material, guys. So that is why, beta, it is called as product cost. That is directly in relation to the product. Okay, guys. Now, beta, we still have certain more things to be done as such, guys. It is not that we are finished with this entire chapter. Guys, the name of your syllabus, beta, is cost and management accounting. Management accounting ka matlab hota hai, beta. Management accounting basically means assisting the management, beta, in decision making. Management accounting, beta, is nothing but use of this costing information, beta, for the purpose of decision making. That becomes management accounting. Okay. When someone asks you, beta, as to what is the meaning of the word management accounting, you should know that management accounting is basically using information for the purpose of decision making. That is management accounting. Now guys, what is the objective of cost accounting? What is that we actually need out of cost accounting as such, guys? Itna sab pad liya beta, ye already padha chuka hu beta, I'm just trying to summarize. What are the objectives of cost accounting? What is the end result that you are basically looking out of cost accounting? What is that you want to derive out of this entire process as such, guys, of cost accounting? Ek second, but I'll just change the batteries. Yes, beta. What is the objective of cost accounting as such, beta? As to what is that you want to get out of this entire process of cost accounting? See, guys, the first most important thing, beta, of cost accounting, beta, is to arrive at the accurate cost of the product. The first most important thing, beta, of cost accounting is without costing as such, beta, you will obviously not know, guys. Without costing as such, beta, you will obviously not know as such, beta, as to what is the accurate cost of a product as such, beta. Accurate costing. Accurate costing. You should know as such, beta, as to what is the cost of a particular product. If you do not know the cost of a particular product as such, beta, it will obviously have an impact, which brings me to the second point as such, beta, determination of selling price. Determination of selling price, guys. And of course, determining the profitability. Determination of selling price, guys, and determining the profitability. The first point, beta, here is to compute the cost of the product, guys. The second point here, beta, is determination of selling price, guys, and profitability. And profitability. Samajh gaye, sir. Bahut achha, beta, samajh gaye toh. The third important, guys, see, guys, without costing as such, guys, you will obviously not know the accurate cost of a product. Without that, beta, you will not be able to determine the correct selling price of a product, guys, and the profitability of the organization. It is very important, beta, that you price your product properly. It is very important. We discussed so many things, beta, the other day also, guys. I was telling you examples of electric vehicles of Tata Motors and everything. The third important part, beta, is that cost accounting should help you, beta, in cost control. Cost accounting as such, beta, should help you in cost control. Ab ye kya hai, sir? Cost control ka matlab hota hai, beta, is basically trying to stick to your targets. I will tell you the exact difference between the word cost control and cost reduction, guys. Cost control as such, beta, is basically trying to stick to the targets given as such, guys. When I say trying to stick to the targets given, beta, there will be standards. There will be standards set as such, guys. You will measure actual performance. You will measure the actual performance of an organization. Just as say, beta, the standard set was to buy raw material at 10 rupees per kg. Now you are checking as such, beta, as to what is the price at which raw material was purchased. Then compare actuals with standards. Actuals with standards. And beta, perform variance analysis. If there is a deviation as such, guys, if there is a deviation, what is the reason for such a deviation? वापस बेटा अपन क्या पढ़ रहे हैं? We are learning about the objectives of cost accounting as such, beta, as to how cost accounting would actually be useful or what is the end result that we are looking at as such, beta, out of this entire process. So guys, cost accounting, beta, will help us in arriving at the cost of a product. Cost accounting as such, beta, would help us in arriving at the cost of a product. That is what I say, beta, accurate costing of a product, which in turn, beta, will help us in determining the correct selling price of a product, which in turn will help us, beta, in determining the correct selling price of a product as such, guys. Uske baad mein aata hai, beta, cost control. Cost control, beta, is basically ensuring that you do not go overboard. You do not incur more expenses. You stick to your budgets. You stick to your targets. That is cost control as such, guys. This would also help us, beta, in cost reduction. This would also help us, beta, in cost reduction, guys. Ye cost reduction kya hai, beta? It will help us, beta, in identifying non-value added activities. Something that does not add value to the end consumer as such, beta, you will try to eliminate that. Something that does not add value to the end consumer, beta, you will try to eliminate that as such, beta, and reduce the overall cost of the product. Reduce the overall cost of the product as such, guys. Wapis bol raha hu beta. You should know the difference between cost control and cost reduction, guys. Even that is an important theory question, beta, that can come in the examination. So many people are again texting. Yes, beta. So there is cost control, there is cost reduction, guys. In simple words as such, guys, say if I tell you, beta, that you are supposed to take some 10 minutes to solve a particular category of question as such, beta. If I tell you, beta, that you are supposed to take 10 minutes to solve a particular category of question. So if you are trying to stick to that 10 minutes as such, beta, then it will become a case of cost control. मतलब तुम लोग क्या कर रहे हो बेटा, यू आर ट्राइंग टू एंश्योर दैट यू सॉल्व द एंटायर प्रॉब्लम विद इन द गिवन टाइम फ्रेम ऑफ 10 मिनट्स एज सच गाइस, विद इन द गिवन टाइम फ्रेम ऑफ 10 मिनट्स. ऑन द अदर हैंड बेटा, इफ यू क्वेश्चन द टारगेट, इफ यू क्वेश्चन द टारगेट एज सच गाइस, दैट व्हाई 10 मिनट्स, व्हाई कांट वी परफॉर्म द टास्क इन 9 मिनट्स, व्हाई कांट वी सिंप्लीफाई द प्रोसेस ऑफ परफॉर्मिंग द प्रॉब्लम सो दैट इंस्टेड ऑफ टेकिंग 10 मिनट्स वी माइट इवन टेक 9 मिनट्स टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम. Now that will be cost reduction. A classic example of cost reduction, beta, is Apple's new packaging design. We all know, beta, that Apple has implemented a new packaging design. They are not transporting chargers, beta, anymore. The size of the box in which the cell phone is transported has come down, guys. So this has resulted in saving in packaging cost. This has resulted in saving in transportation cost. They have identified, beta, that transportation cost is something that is not adding value to the end consumer. A consumer does not care about how many cell phones are you shipping in one container. One container might cost you $6,000. So all of this, beta, is cost reduction. Remember, a company which emphasizes on cost reduction, beta, would obviously give more importance to the quality of the product. You are not supposed to compromise on the quality of the product. You are not supposed to compromise on the quality of the product as such, guys. It is merely as such, beta, try to reduce the cost of the product by finding out alternative means of performing the production process. By finding out alternative means of performing the production process, guys, by finding out alternate substitutes to raw material. See if you can find a cheaper substitute of raw material without compromising on the quality of the product. That is cost reduction. Cost reduction, beta, basically has a long-term view. You are thinking about the growth of the organization over a longer period. Cost control, beta, on the other side, might have an impact on the quality of the product. Say if I tell you, you are supposed to revise this topic in 1 hour, beta. Tum log 40 minutes tak kar rahe ho, bahut slow ja raha hai. Last mein kya karoge, beta? You will merely turn pages. If I tell you, no matter what happens, beta, you have to finish this class. Tum log fast forward karke khatam kar diye, beta. What is the bloody point? It should not have any impact on the quality. Cost control, beta, can result in having an impact on the quality as such, guys. Imagine, beta, I tell the purchase manager that no matter what happens, you'll have to purchase raw material at 10 rupees per kg. No matter what happens, you'll have to purchase raw material at 10 rupees per kg. This is the standard that has been given to you. Ab market mein, beta, raw material price has increased as such, guys. If he's buying raw material at 11 rupees per kg, his performance evaluation will be bad. So what is he doing, beta? He's buying cheaper raw material at 10 rupees. He's buying a cheaper quality raw material, beta, at 10 rupees. Now, because of this, beta, there's an impact on the quality of the final product that we are selling in the market. Yes or no? All of this, beta, is basically cost control. Cost control, beta, is a preventive action. You are trying to prevent variations. However, this preventive action, beta, can have an impact on the quality of the product. दिस प्रिवेंटिव एक्शन असर बेटा कैन हैव एन इम्पैक्ट ऑन द क्वालिटी ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट. इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस. सो येस ऑन वन साइड वी हैव प्रिवेंटिव फंक्शन, ऑन द अदर साइड कॉस्ट रिडक्शन इज यू नो करेक्टिव एक्शन. Obviously, beta, what is much more important for the growth of the organization, it is cost reduction that is much more important and not cost control. I repeat, it is cost reduction as such, beta, that is even more important for an organization and not cost. Dono chahiye, beta, dono chahiye. Cost control is good, provided it should not have any impact on the quality of the product. But every organization, beta, will continuously work in finding out ways of how can they reduce the cost of the product over a longer period. How can they reduce the cost of a product as such, guys? Things have drastically changed as such, guys. Yes or no? Many products as such, beta, guys, they were 1980s as such, beta, where cell phones were available at a cost of 18,000, 20,000 rupees. Itna bada dabba hota tha, beta. Theek hai? So, things have changed, guys. The cost per unit undergoes a change. Technology changes as such, beta. People keep finding out new ways of performing the work as such, guys. And that is how, beta, cost reduction is possible. And finally, beta, assist management and decision making. Assist management, beta, in decision making. Your objective of cost accounting, beta, is also to identify as such, beta, scope for wastages as such, beta, and see to it, beta, that wastages are reduced. You do not incur wastages. That is again cost reduction, guys. समझने की कोशिश करो बेटा as to what is cost accounting, what is the impact of cost accounting as such, guys. You should understand beta as to what is cost accounting. समझ में आ रहा है ना बेटा? हाँ सर आ रहा है. तो ये बेटा लिखो, then I will give notes regarding cost control and cost reduction. Don't worry about it. First write this in your notebook, guys. We'll end the session soon beta. Today also we might not extend it way too much. अभी ये copy करो guys. Yes, guys. You're all supposed to copy this beta, objectives of cost accounting. Ye sab tumhare study material mein bhi hai beta, the ones that I've given you. I'm assuming you're all copying this beta. Yes, guys, I hope you're all copying this and not wasting time. हो गया क्या बेटा सबका ये? आई जस्ट एक्सप्लेन यू कॉस्ट कंट्रोल एंड कॉस्ट रिडक्शन ऑल्सो सच गाइस, सो लेट अस राइट दैट ऑल्सो बेटा इन योर नोटबुक. सब लोग साथ में ही लिख लो बेटा, ऑल ऑफ यू बेटा, यू कैन राइट इट विद मी ओनली गाइस. कॉस्ट कंट्रोल एंड कॉस्ट रिडक्शन, आई हैव जस्ट एक्सप्लेन यू द डिफरेंस साथ बेटा बिटवीन कॉस्ट कंट्रोल एंड कॉस्ट रिडक्शन. कॉस्ट कंट्रोल में क्या होता है बेटा, वी ट्राई टू बेसिकली बेटा यू ट्राई टू स्टिक टू टारगेट्स, येस और नो? अंडर कॉस्ट कंट्रोल एज सच बेटा वी आर बेसिकली ट्राइंग टू स्टिक टू द टारगेट्स एज सच गाइस. दिस कैन इम्पैक्ट क्वालिटी एज सच गाइस. आई गेव एन एग्जाम्पल बेटा ऑफ परचेज मैनेजर परचेजिंग सम स्टैंडर्ड मटीरियल्स. परचेज मैनेजर एज सच बेटा परचेजिंग सब स्टैंडर्ड मटीरियल गाइस. पॉसिबल और नॉट बेटा? पॉसिबल सर, येस और नो? नो लॉन्ग टर्म सेविंग्स एज सच गाइस. वट एवर इज हैपनिंग बेटा, यू आर बेसिकली ट्राइंग टू स्टिक टू द टारगेट इन द करेंट ईयर ओनली एज सच बेटा. एंड दिस इज इट इज प्रिवेंटिव एक्शन गाइस. इट इज प्रिवेंटिव एक्शन बेसिकली गाइस, इट प्रिवेंट्स डिविएशंस फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड्स. इट प्रिवेंट्स डिविएशंस फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड्स. वापस बोलो बेटा, आई हैव जस्ट एक्सप्लेन यू रिगार्डिंग कॉस्ट कंट्रोल गाइस. यू कैन मेक अ नोट ऑफ इट डायरेक्टली बेटा. आफ्टर कॉस्ट कंट्रोल बेटा वी हैव कॉस्ट रिडक्शन. कॉस्ट रिडक्शन में बेटा यू क्वेश्चन द टारगेट्स एज सच गाइस, येस और नो? सो बेसिकली गाइस, रिड्यूस कॉस्ट विदाउट इम्पैक्टिंग क्वालिटी. Without impacting the quality of the product. There will be long-term savings, no doubt about it. As such, guys. There's absolutely no doubt about that as such, better. It is corrective action, guys. I gave an example, better, of Apple's new packaging design. ठीक है गाइस, आई होप यू ऑल रिटन दिस एज सच गाइस. फिर भी एक बार अभी लिख लो गाइस फटाफट, कॉस्ट कंट्रोल एंड कॉस्ट रिडक्शन बोल के. अगर जस्ट इन केस नहीं हुआ तो ये नोट्स में लिख लो बेटा. दिस कैन कम एज अ थ्योरी क्वेश्चन गाइस इन द एग्जाम. यस बेटा, कॉपी करो गाइस. Copy this better now. Yes, guys, if you're not done with it, beta, you can pause the screen and then do it. I'll end the session here only as such, beta. We are done with the major theory part of this chapter, guys. There might be a couple of things left here and there, guys. But I would be starting a fresh chapter, beta, tomorrow. Because I'll see you guys in the next session, beta. And do not forget, beta, to revise properly. Ensure, beta, that you're revising each and every topic properly. Theek hai, beta? See you guys in the next session. Bye-bye, guys.